this game, Randy. This is the first conference game for both of these teams, and kind of in a funny way, this is they're both coming off of open weeks, which is a little bit uncharacteristic, but you know Jay Thomas and Charlie Stubbs have these teams ready to play.
Let's talk about the storylines of this one today. Let's begin with the Colonels of Nicholls and their quarterback situation. We're going to see not one, but two quarterbacks on the football field today, Toscani Figueroa and Bo Hebert.
Well, when Toscani Figueroa rushed for 281 yards, that kind of inserted him, if you will, into more of a role in playing as a quarterback spot. Bo Hebert does a great job. He's a very good pocket passer, but Figueroa brings another dimension to this offense, and Charlie Stubbs is trying to find the right chemistry.
And Figueroa will get the start for Coach Stubbs and the Colonels today. Meanwhile, the other side, the Demons from Northwestern State, specifically will spotlight the defense and Leslie Demershay. This is a defensive line that attacks the quarterback.
Well, he is a very aggressive guy. He plays off that defensive tackle position, and he just is a surly player. He comes with a big attitude, and really, Leslie Demer is one of those guys, Randy, that you'll see he has to be double-teamed for the other offense to be successful.
All right, good looking matchup, Nicholls and Northwestern State today. Shay and I up in the booth. Meanwhile, our third member of the broadcast team, Erin Cofield, roaming the sidelines. She has more as we get ready for kickoff. Erin?
I sure do, Randy. Another storyline that we'll be watching tonight is regarding the coaches. Let's talk first about the Nicholls University head coach, Charlie Stubbs. He's in his fourth season with the Colonels. He had a lot of experience as an offensive coordinator before he became the head coach here. But here's where the wrench comes in. The head coach before him was Jay Thomas, who will be on the sideline for Northwestern State University. He is in his first season as head coach there. He did spend 14 seasons here at Nicholls, six as head coach, the big year in 2005 when they were named conference champions. All week long, a storyline everybody has wanted to discuss. However, Jay Thomas has insisted this is not about him. This is not about him coming back down here. This is about his players, his team, and getting that first championship win under their belt.
South All right, Erin, appreciate that. We'll be checking in with Erin throughout the broadcast. We're ready for kickoff here in Thibodaux, Louisiana, as we celebrate 50 years of Southland Conference football. Opening kickoff between the Demons and the Colonels coming up next. The game of the week on the Southland Conference Television Network, brought to you by Mid-South Bank, the official bank of the Southland Conference. It's time to love your bank. By State Farm. Visit texas.statefarm.com for your chance to win the ultimate VIP experience. And let State Farm help you get to a better state. And by Jostens, the official championship ring provider of the Southland Conference. Jostens, the Ring of Champions.
We are Louisiana's future.
We are regionally ranked.
We are nationally accredited.
We are progressive.
We are passionate.
We are purple.
We are global.
We are local.
We are
Northwestern State University.
Local.
Global.
Northwestern State.
In Thibodaux, Guidry Stadium, we are ready for some football. The student body here from Nicholls has made their way out. Fans starting to file in. Good tailgate today, and Nicholls will receive. Northwestern State will kick off. Chris Moore has the duties for the Demons. And we are ready to roll here in Thibodaux. Good to have you with us on the Southland Conference Television Network. Ball goes through the end zone, and Nicholls will take over to start this football game on offense here this afternoon. In bragging rights online, this is a good rivalry. Just reading about the history, Shay. This is two good matchups, programs that have knocked heads against each other for quite some time here.
And, you know, Randy, really, you think about coming into conference play, the big deal for these guys, both teams and both coaches, you know, there's a lot on the line right now. You want to get off the schneid. or start the conference play on a positive note. And both of these teams last couple of years have struggled. And really, it's very important. It's way more important than you will just battling for that NSU trophy.
First play from scrimmage for Nicholls. Toscani Figueroa, your starting quarterback. We'll go through the State Farm starting lineups here in just a moment. But first play underway. And let's take a look at those State Farm starting lineups. Here this afternoon in Thibodeau for Nicholls up front. Rafe Plaisant, pretty good one. He's been around a while. Left guard. Caleb Klein as well, the right guard. He's a 300-pound junior. Marcus Washington, you're going to hear his name quite a bit out of the backfield. Also one of the favorite targets of these quarterbacks. They try to get their passing game going here at Nicholls. Second down play for the Colonels. Figueroa brought down around the 35-yard line. Stop made there by Adam Jones. Take a look at the State Farm starting lineups. Take a look at the defense now for Northwestern State. Chris Boone, the defensive coordinator, likes his group. There's the fellas up front. We featured Leslie Deemer, the defensive tackle. And then the linebackers, Jones, Black, two good ones as well. Three guys that can make plays, and they're in the secondary. Claiborne, Sorrell, White, Burt White, a veteran for Northwestern State.
Well, nice job right there, Marcus Washington, Randy, after two consecutive runs by Toscani Figueroa. The first one, design run. The second one, he was looking to throw the ball, didn't find a receiver open, and ends up picking up a first down on a short gain, and come right back with Marcus Washington. Does a good job of picking up eight yards on first down.
Approaching midfield already, 42-yard line for Nicholls. And this is an offense they feel like they've made progress on this season, and still some kinks to work out as they continue the season.
Yeah, it's Washington banging it right in the middle again. He's going to pick up about 2.5 yards. He will be about a yard short, Randy, up the first down. Certainly like to see third and shorts as an offensive coordinator, offensive side. So a little bit of beef coming in. Josh Dudley checking out.
Well, the top rushers on this Nicholls football team, Marcus Washington, of course, the go-to guy, but your quarterback right there, Toscani Figueroa, second when it comes to rushing attempts. There's Washington again. He'll cross the 45-yard line. The chains will move once again. Another first down for the Colonels.
Well, Ryan Sorrell comes up from the safety spot, and he does make a very clean tackle on Washington, but again, third and short. Kind of just gets picks up that first down and kind of works his way right in the middle line of scrimmage. And I see number 85, Nick Skelfo. He's tight end. They love this guy. Like the way he plays and blocks at the point of attack, and he got a little bit nicked up on that last play.
Number 17, Brad Nelson, has checked in for Nicholls. First and 10 now. They'll mark it at the 46. And off again up the middle. Maybe a yard on that play.
Deion Simon, number 99, 6'4", 322 pounds. Just kind of plug it up the middle. When you're anything over 300, I don't care if it's one or if it's 100 over 300, you can plug up the middle pretty well.
Absolutely.
Simon doing a good job there for the Demons defense.
Dalton Hilliard, Jr., number 22. He's the backup to Marcus Washington. He's checked in as well. We'll see a lot of rotation here for Nicholls.
That chips receiver down to the wide side, bottom of your screen.
Figueroa, pass is caught there around the 45-yard line. Eric Buchanan with the catch for Nicholls. Buchanan, a senior from Aberdeen, Mississippi.
And he fought forward and leaned backwards, and he fought through three of those Demon defenders, Randy, to pick up the first down. And good job sitting down and making himself available to the quarterback. Toscani did a nice job of just laying it out there. It's kind of an easy pitch and catch, and then Buchanan hanging on and picking up that first down.
They'll get it out to the 44-yard line now. Washington gets the handoff. He's got running room up the middle, approaching the 35. Ball's a little short of that, down to the 36. So another big gainer there for Marcus Washington. So an opening drive establishing the running game, Chip.
Well, you see the big guys up front, and they made a nice crease and a good seam there, Randy. Listen, we have seen the Colonels offense run that play without much success, but not giving up on it. You like the way they go back to it, and they pick up 8 yards on first down.
Well, so far this season, this Nicholls offense averaging just over 400 yards per game, most of it on the run, trying to get that passing game going. Figueroa is brought down on the play. Stop is made by Keelan Johnson, one of the defensive ends here for Northwestern State. Good defense, as we mentioned at the top. This unit's got 13 sacks already, so they've been putting pressure on quarterbacks all season long.
Well, and you see the speed right there of Keelan Johnson, because he comes from the offside, and he runs Figueroa down, and really, he holds him to no gain. Toscano was just fortunate to get back to the line of scrimmage. Good speed off the edge by Johnson.
Third and short now from the 36-yard line. Figueroa gets loose. Down there, the 30-yard line. That's enough for a first down and then some.
Well, Randy, this is what makes Toscani Figueroa so important to this Colonels offense. He's going to get hit in the backfield, and an arm tackle is not going to bring this guy down. I mean, look, there's a clear shot there, but Figueroa just powers right through it. He is 6'3", 210 pounds, and he uses that strength, that power, and that speed to run through the arm tackle and fight forward for some extra yards, picks up the first down.
Figueroa from Lafayette, a couple hours from here, Crowley High School, and just a sophomore. Good size, as you mentioned, 6'3", 210. Chains move again for Nicholls. Now at the 30-yard line. This is Figueroa looking downfield. Open receiver. He's got his man. Nice pickup for Nicholls. Catch is made by Hayden Cardiff. The big tight end, 6'4", 210-pounder from Georgia.
Boy, and he was wide open with Cardiff. And it's again, Charlie Stubbs, imaginative on the offensive side. You see Figueroa has a pump fake down the middle of the field that holds the safeties. He's able to drop it down in the bucket. Cardiff right there on the grab. And, man, I tell you what, very impressive opening drive for the Colonels.
Well, this is a kind of a clock-eating drive. This is what they want. And points, of course, the exclamation point to get it on the board. Washington up the middle.
Ooh.
Takes a big hit there around the 1 or 2 yard line.
Looked like he was going in, and Deion Simon, number 99, just gave him a big bear hug and pulled it backwards.
Here's Simon, 315-pounder. Look at his numbers this season. He's got two of those 13 sacks.
I'm looking at the numbers, but I'm also seeing some guns coming out of the sleeves.
he's not hiding those.
No, sir. Well, Marcus Washington, he was running straight. He went in and just got a big old bear hug there, and Simon was able to keep him out of the end zone.
Second and goal to go now for the Colonels. The ball goes to Washington.
No
signal
ball,
is
yeah.
in. Man,
yeah,
a signal.
There it is.
Touchdown, Colonels. Marcus Washington caps off Nicholls' opening drive of the afternoon with a short touchdown.
Hey, Randy, I don't know if you could script a better opening drive for the Colonels than what they just put on display and getting in for the touchdown. Ran the ball very effectively when they needed to, threw the ball, a couple of big plays there, and
Extra point.
No good. Sailed a little wide left.
That was Andrew Dolan, who missed the extra point. That'll drive a coach crazy, but they're on the board. 6-0. We're early here in the first quarter in Thibodeau. Nicholls on top of Northwestern State.
Hey, look at Mommy.
Maybe the light hurts his eyes.
Maybe she's just not hungry. Maybe it's a phase.
Avoiding eye contact is one early sign of autism. Learn the others today. When some people struggle with their mortgage payments, they become frozen, petrified, not knowing what to do. They do nothing. But the people who do something, the people who take action, are far more likely to get the most positive outcome. Making Home Affordable is a free government program. Call now to talk one-on-one with a housing expert about the options that are right for you. Real help, real answers, right now.
Maybe he's really focused.
Back live at Thibodeau, 7:52 to go, first quarter. Coach Stubbs talking it over with his guys, and that opening drive got to be happy with it. The missed extra point, he doesn't like that, but they march right down, methodical drive to open this football game.
Well, and really, Randy, if you think about the way they did it, using all facets of the offense, the run game, quarterback run game, getting the ball a little short passes, the little deeper ball down to Cardiff, the tight end. I mean, there was just a very efficient, clean, no penalty drive, and other than the extra point, perfect.
And there's Andrew Dolan. He will kick off for Nicholls. Back to receive is number 33, Ed Egan. He's the main return man, and Moan Claiborne as well. It'll be Egan from the 1 yard line. Egan will bring it out. Crossing the 20s, brought down around the 23, 24 yard line, and that's where the Demons will begin their first offensive series of this afternoon. Ed Egan can do it all for this Northwestern State football team. We'll talk about him, especially on the offensive side, and how he's transitioned, Shea, from defense. They said, hey, this guy's got hands. Let's put him in his receiving corps, see what he can do. He's already a great kickoff and punt return guy, and they've been happy with the results so far. Here's Zach Atkins, your new quarterback this season for Northwestern State. Numbers so far already over 1,100 yards, 8 touchdowns. They come out throwing right away to open this first series. Take a look at the State Farm starting lineups now. Up front for Northwestern State, Cole Douglas, Jones, Boyd, and Chisakit player. He's been around a while. He's a playmaker up front. And then you've got Atzenweiler in that backfield for the Demons. Tucker Nims, they like him at tight end. Louis Ollier, the veteran receiver for Northwestern State.
When you talk about this offensive front for Northwestern State, Pace Murphy was a game-time decision, starting right tackle. He's not able to play today, so Tishakid player moves from the guard over to that tackle spot. Terrence Boyd, the freshman, 6'3", 14 pounder, moves into the right guard spot.
State Farm starting lineups for the Colonels defense. Up front, Young, Trench, and Carter. And then that linebacking core, they got to make some plays today and put some pressure on Zach Atkins as well. And there's the secondary. Couple new faces from a year ago for Nicholls.
Gonna get a false start here. Louis Ollier. Going that inside slot receiver on the wide side of the field. Anyway, just looking down there, he had Ronald Tyler lined up over the top of him, man-to-man coverage. And you had mentioned with Ollier, veteran receiver, he is really a go-to guy that's been around for a while, averaging 18 yards a catch.
Well, head coach Jay Thomas, of course, back with the program. He had been there, of course, on the staff for Coach Bradley Del Pivato. Pass is caught there.
Wow,
that's Garrett Atzenweiler with the catch. Took a hit and bounced off that. And crosses the 35-yard line.
Randy, what a finish on third down after you get the false start penalty. And Atzenweiler does a great job of not only catching up, but Atkins did a fantastic job because he got leveled just as soon as he let go of the ball.
Right.
Garrett Atzenweiler not only catches it, he is short of the first down when he makes that catch, but he runs through two Colonel defenders to pick up the first down.
First and 10 from the 36. Pass intended for Louis Ollier.
Nice defense there.
Yeah, they got a handout. Let's see who made the play. That was Fort. Yeah, Jordan Hanbury making the stop there. Got that hand on it. Good coverage on Ollier. Well, here at Nicholls, you've got a team that's obviously struggled, Shea, in conference play today. They're trying to take that step as a program and snap that losing streak in Southland Conference action, and they feel like they've made progress this season in a lot of areas within the program. There's Addison Wiley. Big yardage. Crossing the 45 down to the 47. Again, the chains will move for Northwestern State.
You know, you talk about bootlegs and naked bootlegs, and you see that that was really just a quick pitch, like a zip out to Addison Wiley, Randy. So he didn't have a whole lot of blocking in front of him, but it was a quick pitch to see if you could get him to outflank the defense. He was able to do that and pick up the first down.
Last year, Northwestern State 4-7. They've got 16 starters back. They've got some guys within the program that had some experience, so they feel like they were able to plug. And we mentioned one of those guys that shifted a little bit is Ed Egan, and we'll see him here on offense. You know, you experiment a little bit, and especially in spring football, you find out how guys can help you in other ways, and they found out Ed Egan could definitely be an impact player on offense.
He's a very athletic guy, a lot of speed, and he played a lot on special teams, and really that's where he started to kind of showcase what he can do. And certainly when you think about getting guys out in the open field area, great guy to have in your arsenal, trying to get him the balls in the bubble screens and anywhere where he's got a chance to make a play. And as they say, out in space, he's a very dangerous player. A little bit of a unique looking formation by the Demons.
Third and short here. Oh, what a handoff. That's Robert Walker. Ball's loose. Colonels say they've got it around the 35. We'll look for the signal. Indeed, Nicholls recovers. Costly turnover here by Northwestern State.
Rob Walker, Randy, the way he hit the hole, he hit it with speed to burn. Puts a 360 move on the defender. Gets enough yards for the first down, but then he takes a shot. He gets rocked. Take a look here. It's a replay. Rob Walker hits it up in there, and you see, why don't you make that move right there? And as he's going out, he starts to lose the ball. It looks like Jordan Hanbury again on the strip. The ball was already loose. Hanbury finishes it off and gets a strip, and you see him pulling that ball, comes out, and the Colonels are back on offense.
Toscani Figueroa out there again for the second series this afternoon. This one starts on the 35. Flag is going to be down around the 30. Pass intended there for Marcus Washington, who couldn't haul it in. So Figueroa the starter today, and I think we're, at least based on what we've heard, we're going to see some of Bo Hebert as well this afternoon.
Yeah, we're definitely going to see both quarterbacks, but Coach Stubbs is kind of coy when we're talking to him about who he's going to play, when and where, what situation.
Both were behind the starter, Caitlin Henderson, when the season began.
Yeah, felt they had an illegal block call, but after conferring, the field judge, line judge, and referee, they decide it's not a penalty. Or it is a legal block. We'll go with that. This is a new look Colonel team, Randy. I mean, you see
really
the way
is.
That Figueroa is managing the offense, and Marcus Washington, he is the leading receiver on this team, and it's not by a little, it's by a bunch. So your running back is getting a lot of touches.
Pressure coming on Figueroa, gets it off. Oh. That nearly was picked off there around the 40-yard line.
Josh Hanbury, Randy, yeah. You see that was a little tentative going across the middle there because he knew he was running into no man's land. He gets that one hand up to catch that ball, but he did not want to get out too far because he felt like he was going to get pelted if he did.
Some updates from around the conference today. Look at this. Could there be an upset brewing in Huntsville? Sam Houston State at the half.
Cardinals hanging tough.
Oh, it's only 7-3 Bearcats. We'll keep an eye on that one. Also, first quarter this afternoon, Nebraska Kearney in Conway, Arkansas, taking on Central Arkansas. And the Bears lead at 3-0. Central Arkansas coming off that disappointing home loss to McNeese last week to snap their home streak on the stripes there in Conway.
Yeah,
so they're looking to bounce back today.
Yeah, big win by the Cowboys, and you know, certainly kind of just sends a little bit of a message, if you will, throughout the conference. And you know, Stephen F. Austin is going to be making some noise as well. A lot of good things going on. That's a big win by the Cowboys, though.
It really was. They looked impressive, and then next Saturday they've got a big one. in Lake Charles. They welcome in Sam Houston State.
It'll be two top 10 teams playing.
First and 10 for the 45-yard line. Hand off, that's Dalton Hilliard Jr. Helmet goes flying off there around the 46-yard line of Hilliard. You recognize the name, his father, Dalton Hilliard, of course, longtime NFL player, star with down the road, New Orleans Saints.
Yeah, but Baton Rouge as well.
Absolutely.
Just wholesale substitution right now, Randy coming in, so four different players.
Xavier Marcos is in as well for Nicholls, number 80. Second down and seven now for the Colonels. Figueroa's pass falls incomplete around the 45-yard line. Pass was intended for Demon Bolt. Bolt got a hand on it, but good coverage there by the Demon secondary.
Adam Jones was right on the spot. He read the play perfectly. Figueroa's going to lock in onto Demon Bolt. He looks at him immediately, and Adam Jones, Randy, read it perfectly off that safety spot. Kind of came right over the top and just raked the right hand through, and it was an easy pass to defend. And now third and 7 yards. Yep, third and seven. See a lot of Demon defenders around the line of scrimmage.
Figueroa, pressure's coming. He is on the run. He's going to be forced out of bounds around the 47-yard line. Pressure came very quickly there by the Demon.
Well, and I like the aggressive play call by the Demon's defense. Dialing up a lot of pressure on Toscani Figueroa. Again, he's only a sophomore. He's not played a lot of quarterback. And they felt like the best way to the Demons is to get him out of the pocket and make him on the run. And they did a good job of lane containment and kept him short of the first down. Good aggressive defensive play calling.
Connor Freeu will have his first punt attempt of the day for Nicholls. Ed Egan and Claiborne back for Northwestern State. Egan will let that one bounce. Good coverage there by the Nicholls special teamers inside the 5-yard line.
Byron Cobb did a great job on special teams, Randy, downing that inside the 5-yard line.
Taking a break, 6-0. Nicholls leading Northwestern here in the first.
At MidSouth Bank, we're dedicated to providing loans that allow our customers to achieve their business and personal dreams. That's one promise you can bank on. We're not just business associates, we're neighbors. We're committed to our customers and the strength of our local economy. Here at MidSouth Bank, responsibility matters. With over 61 locations and still growing in Louisiana and Texas, discover how our customers are finding strength in numbers at MidSouth Bank.
In the NCAA Division I Football Championship Subdivision, the game is played with perseverance, integrity, passion, character, and sportsmanship as he works to honor the game and respect his teammates, opponents, officials, and fans. Every FCS player grows in his responsibilities as a student athlete and as a member of his campus and community. The NCAA Division I Football Championship Subdivision. Every down, every day.
Back live in Thibodeau, 2:25 to go, first quarter. Northwestern State and the Colonels from Nicholls. Rivalry series continues today. Charlie Stubbs handing out instructions. He feels good about the direction of the program. They've struggled, there's no doubt about it, especially in conference play. And he feels like some of the pieces now beginning to get in place now for this program. And we'll see if it produces a win here this afternoon over the Demons.
So far offensively, they've done a good job. And special teams-wise on this punt, Randy, downing inside the 5-yard line is pretty good stuff.
Atkins with the pass attempt, and that is dropped by Cody Jones, a sophomore. He would love to get that one back.
Yeah, that was a nice throw by Atkins. And really, that's a play that you have to make, certainly when you're deep in your own end. You're coming off the 3-yard line, and you've got a chance to pick up 4 or 5 yards just to get out of the shadow of the goalpost. not to be able to come up with that ball. Cody Jones got to make that catch.
Looking down play. Handoff goes to Garrett Atzenweiler. Takes a couple of tough hits there around the five-yard line before he's brought down. Tackle made.
You talk about a tough physical runner. Atzenweiler, 5'11", 217-pound junior. Randy, like a battering ram. Doesn't pick up any yards. That was three hard-fought yards because there were four or five, if not more, red jerseys laying licks and running all around it.
Big hit from T.J. Lumar. Four Nicholls. There are the numbers this season for Atkins. Eight touchdowns, six interceptions.
This is a big third down right now, Randy. And I know you talk about times and points in the game, but right now in this game, this is a big third down.
Atkins over the middle. That was to Olye. He took a big hit around the 18-yard line. Ronald Tyler, number three there, four Nicholls. Take a look at this again.
The ball's a little bit behind him. He goes back trying to catch the ball, and he just absolutely gets level. Not able to hang on.
DeMont Bolt right at midfield for Nicholls. They're going to get some good field position coming up as the Demons are forced to punt it away. Chase Tossin with the punt for Northwestern State. That'll bounce around the 40. Yards. Nicholls tries to, something with it, though. Gets a couple of yards, but they're going to get the football back, and they will be in good shape here late first quarter in Thibodeau. Colonels on top, 6-0.
Are you sure we should take this billboard down?
People find out State Farm does car loans as well as they do insurance. Our bank is through.
Good point. Grab an edge.
Look, there's two guys on the State Farm Borrow Better Banking sign.
No, for real, there's two dudes on the State Farm
Borrow Better Banking sign.
Gentlemen, please get down from the State Farm Borrow Better Banking sign. Phil, get the hose.
Okay, he's getting the hose.
All right, let's go.
Want to borrow better? Contact your local State Farm agent about a car loan that could save you hundreds.
Southland strong.
Manning Field at John L. Guidry Stadium in Thibodeau, Louisiana. Campus of Nicholls University here in Thibodeau, and beautiful day of football. Thought we might catch a little shower on the way down here today, but it stayed off and things are clear right now. Good shape for the Colonels. Good field position, and they'll start it off with a handoff to Washington. He'll cross the 40-yard line. Picks up close to 4 yards on that play. So first few series of this football game, Shea, they've established the running game. They've established that there could be some space there today for Marcus Washington.
Well, Marcus Washington, Randy, he is ninth all time in Nicholls rushing history. So he's a guy that you have to account for, and I really like the way that he finished that last play. It looked like he was going to try to bounce it out to the outside, but instead he decided to fight forward and pick up more yards straight ahead, and they're a little bit more tougher yards, but he did a better job for his offense.
Pressure on Figueroa. Pass is caught by Bolt down near the 25-yard line, so Good job by Figueroa to elude that pressure and get that football off.
Yeah, great point, Randy, because Figueroa does just, he pulls the rabbit out of the hat. Take a look at the pressure. You're going to see it coming from Adam Jones, number three. They've got a good line on Figueroa, as does Leslie Deamer, but he's athletic enough to spin out, roll out, and then once he does, he finds DeMond Bolt downfield, picks up the first down.
Clock winding down here in the first quarter.
It's very difficult when you're Chris Boone, first-year defensive coordinator for the Demons, and you know that you've got the right defense called, but yet you can't capture the quarterback behind the line of scrimmage and or force the errant throw. So not only did he elude the defense, but he was able to make a good throw to his wide receiver and pick up that first down.
Right now, let's check in with Aaron Cofield on the sidelines with a little weather update. How's it feel down there, Aaron?
Guys, it may be mid-October, but I tell you what, you can tell it is South Louisiana. It's like 90 degrees out down here. That's something that Northwestern head coach Jay Thomas, he pays close attention to. I'm told that what he does is he has a formula where he adds up the temperature and the humidity percentage. If it's over 150, they take extra precautions. There's a lot of fans. They warmed up without their pads on, and there is a big box of apples over there. They even pay attention to their diet, making sure that they drink lots of water and eat lots of fruit, preparing for the game so it doesn't become an issue.
Good points there.
Ooh, I just learned something.
I went to class there. The research they do to prepare out there. But you know what? You've got to take the precautions and make sure these athletes are taken care of. Figueroa on the keeper. He's met right there around the 25-yard line. Tyler Roussel leading the stop there for the Demons.
Well, Randy, that is just great presence by the junior linebacker staying at home. Toscani Figueroa had everything going out to the wide side, left of the field, and Roussel stays home and comes up with a good stop.
Very quick opening quarter here in Thibodeau. A good start for the Colonels of Nicholls. Northwestern State hoping to get something going as well. We're going to the second quarter here in Thibodeau. Colonels on top, 6-0.
Every day, kids witness bullying. They want to help, but don't know how. Teach your kids how to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
Thanks for calling the GED Pep Talk Center. Jerry Siller speaking. Your level 7 in your face pep talk.
I can keep pushing you. Believe me, I'm good at it. But at some point, you're going to need to start pushing yourself.
See, once you've got your GED diploma, you'll feel so good about yourself.
You tell them. You can't change your past, but you can definitely change your future.
That makes me so happy, I'm ready to bust out a dance.
Mr. Trejo, can I transfer this guy to you? My gentle technique isn't really working. You need something a little more
persuasive.
Yes!
You listen, and you listen good.
Hey, where's my sandwich?
Terry?
Terry!
Take it from me to King DMC. It's a real cool thing to get your GED.
Get that diploma!
Now hold on and we'll find you free GED classes. Capiche?
Whatever motivation you need, we've got a pep talk for you. Get your GED pep talk and find free classes at yourged.org.
People think I'm trash, but they're wrong. Today I'm just an aluminum can. One day, I could be a stadium.
Ready for quarter number two here in Thibodeau. The Nicholls fans are fired up. That's a good opening quarter. Cheering on their football team here today. Toscani Figueroa, the quarterback for Nicholls, opening the second quarter. Second down play now for Nicholls from the 25.
Ooh.
Absolutely nothing there at all for Figueroa. Say hello to Deion Simon right there. How about that play?
Well, I don't know how you missed number 99. He's a guy that we talked about, 322 pounds. Comes right up the gut. Take a look. Figueroa doesn't even have a chance, Randy. He just beats the block at the point of attack. Runs right over the top of Figueroa. Toscani's like, yeah, that's the proverbial, what was that license plate on that truck? It was 99, special plates.
Absolutely there. They lost 5 yards on that play, so now you're looking, they mark it at the 30. It's a third and 15 all of a sudden for the Colonels. Figueroa looking to throw, got a little bit of time, he's got his receiver as well. That's Bolt. That's DeMont Bolt. That's a touchdown for Nicholls. Good protection in the pocket for Figueroa. He let it fly. Great catch, by the way, on the other end by Bolt. And he takes it in.
How about that on a third and 15, dialing up a big play. Bolt is an inside receiver here. You see the little play action pass. Figueroa, very calm in the pocket, Randy. Steps up in there and he just leads Bolt perfectly. And DeMond Bolt gets the ball just inside the pylon. Looked like he was going to step out around the half-yard line, but he gets the ball across the pylon, and that's a touchdown.
Point after is good by Andrew Dolan. We'll take a break. Early, second quarter. Colonel strike again. They lead it 13-0.
I'm one unlucky guy. The chance of being involved in a robbery is 1 in 757. The chances of being struck by lightning. 750,000.
Please fasten your seatbelts for unexpected turbulence.
The chances of being a victim in an airline crash, 1 in 29 million. Hey, could I get some peanuts? The chances of being involved in a car crash are far greater than lightning strikes and plane crashes. And if you are texting while driving, your risk of crash increases 23 times. Now, I may be an unlucky guy, but I don't have to be part of that statistic, and neither do you. Drive responsibly.
Wow, these are really good.
You act surprised. Practice makes perfect.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you.
Back live at Thibodeau. 13-0 after that last touchdown from Toscani Figueroa to DeMond Bolt. And a very good start for the Colonels here this afternoon as they kick it off here back to Northwestern State.
Randy, the most impressive thing about that particular drive for me was Figueroa's poise in the pocket on third and 15. After he had just taken a big sack, he comes right back on the next play, steps up into the pocket comfortably, doesn't get too antsy, doesn't get his feet too happy, and delivers a perfect strike to Bolt for the touchdown.
So, Demons shut out so far here, early second quarter. Head coach Jay Thomas. Hoping something can get going here. Robbie Brown is the offensive coordinator. And they put a new offense in here for the Demons. Brown came over from Valdosta State and won the Division II National Championship a year ago. Again, Northwestern State, Nicholls from John L. Guidry Stadium here in Thibodeau today. Here's Zach Atkins in trouble. Good pressure again from Nicholls. Not much going there for Atkins. So looking for a little consistency today. They're struggling kind of getting out of the gates here this afternoon.
Well, they really have. And this defense, Colonel defense, doing a great job. Cameron Brown was in on that. And he's the guy who initially forced Atkins out of the pocket and into the coverage. So this, again, a very good aggressive Colonel defense coming up, walking up on receivers.
Pass out to his wide receiver, that's Brian Mitchell. Mitchell, a junior. 14 catches coming in from Mitchell. That's number 15.
He had to go down and grab that one, though, Randy. You see, it was second down and 10, and it's now third and 7. So only able to pick up 3 yards. That ball was thrown just a little low. Did a nice job of going down and fielding it on top of the shoelaces, but not a whole lot of yards to be gained.
Northwestern State with just 50 total yards of offense in that opening quarter compared to 106 for Nicholls.
Trying to throw a little check down, and he got it down to Ramil Morris. but Chris Berman was right there on the stop. They're going to call the pass incomplete now. Berman was right there. He, what an important player he is this team. He's got two picks already, a forced fumble, five tackles for loss, a couple of sacks to go along with it. So big force on that defense. He comes up and he's able to separate Ramil Morris from the ball, forcing the punt. So what? Cardinals look like they're going to have good field position again. Punt return guy standing on his 38-yard line.
Demons forced to punt it away here from their own 28-yard line. Mob Bolt is back for Nicholls. He'll field it, nearly fumble the football around the 32-yard line. Good coverage by Northwestern State. He was really close to losing that football.
Yeah.
Got his hand on it before he secured it. So Nicholls will get it back, leading 13-0 here early second quarter in Thibodaux. Well, it is the 50th anniversary. The Southland Conference 50th anniversary all-time football team presented by Mid-South Bank. We've been looking at all the candidates and the running back. This is my pick here, Shay. I really like what Larry Sinners, you know, meant to Stephen F. Austin, meant to the conference. And of course, he went on to a 14-year NFL career, a couple of Super Bowls. You can vote on Facebook.com/Southland Conference to vote for your favorite per position, and it's a lot of fun. You really check up in the history of the conference of guys who've stepped forward. So yeah, that's my pick. We're going to be taking a look at yours.
And I would have to say, I applaud your pick. I think it's a great one. And there's a lot of outstanding running backs that are on the list. You even have an opportunity to write in for guys. And the deal is, it's a position per week is the way it's going. Last week was quarterback. This week is running back. And, you know, I think it's a great opportunity for the fans and supporters of the conference to get a chance to let their voices be heard.
Well, you really,
and you're going to get my pick in the second half.
I can't wait for that. Figueroa, deep ball inside the 30. No flag. Yep, we do have a flag down. Pass was intended there for Eric Buchanan. We'll see who was flagged, who pushed off. Perhaps Darius Poulard. We'll see if it's on him or not.
It's not looking good for the defense, the Demons. But the flag did come in a little bit late for the field, Judge.
Defense, number 26, 15-yard penalty.
Yeah, it's going to be called on Darius Poulard, the freshman. Too much contact right around that 30-yard line. Take a look at it again here.
Well, Figueroa showing a little bit of arm strength here, taking a shot downfield. Great point in the game. And you know, look at that, miss. Well, that's a tough call. Kind of incidental contact. Official saw it differently. And 15-yard penalty. And then now the Colonel offense is up on the 49-yard line.
Figueroa tries to turn the corner. Crosses midfield. Knocked out of bounds. Around the 49-yard line.
Purely a design run play. He has Josh Hanberry, number 14, coming across the front of the formation. Fakes that little zone read handoff. He's got a couple of blockers out front. Does a good job of following those, picking up positive yards. But how about Leslie Deamer defensively chasing down that play and forcing Figueroa out of bounds, holding him at a 3-yard gain? It's in defensive tackles. You see him running sideline to sideline, you better watch out.
You don't want that contact.
No, sir. Not when they're up to full speed.
Second down at 7. Figueroa over the middle. Around the 43-yard line. That's Darryl Watson.
Yeah, Watson did a great job, right? That ball was a little bit high. And he's down there in the middle of the field and right in front of the quarterback, but he goes up, snags it.
Well, so far today we've seen on these offensive series, Shay, from Nicholls, they're really a balanced attack. They're not afraid. They've shown signs they could throw the football. We talked with Coach Stubbs. They need to keep improving in that passing game. And you keep a balanced attack. They're eating up a lot of clock so far this afternoon as well. Pass pass is caught again, crossing the 40. That's enough for a first down. It's Figueroa to Darrell Watson again. So back-to-back plays.
Randy, I'll tell you, you talk about the balance on the offense. So far for the Colonels this year after five games, they run the ball for 210 yards a game. They pass it for 197. That's about as balanced as you can be and get using the run and the pass.
First down and 10 now. They move the chains once again down to the 37-yard line. Excellent field position all day for the Colonels. Hand off to Washington. And the stop is made there by Pat Black, the senior middle linebacker for Northwestern State.
The leading total tackler on this Demons defense does a good job of coming in and wrapping Washington up around the waist and hauling him down for a very short gain.
Nicholls will hit the road next week. Nacogdoches taking on Stephen F. Austin. That'll be our Southland Conference game of the week again. We'll be there in Nacogdoches at Homer Bryce Stadium. Always good to head to the East Texas, the Piney Woods there. Still no sign. It's been Toscani Figueroa the entire football game so far in this first half, but he's been productive. Thought we'd see a little bit of Bo Hebert, but not yet. We'll see if that changes as the afternoon continues. Eric Buchanan checks back in now for Nicholls. And a third down play now coming up from the 35. They need to reach the 27-yard line for a first down. Figueroa, pass is caught. That's Xavier Marcus.
Just forced out of bounds by Fred Thomas, but I think it's not until he picks up enough for the first down, and that's right. Chains are moving. Good play by Figueroa, recognizing Ryan Sorrell, Randy. He ran on the field late, and he was covering. He had to run all the way across the field to cover the inside receiver. Washington catches, or excuse me, Xavier Marcus catches that ball, does a nice little tight rope, enough of a tight rope down the sidelines to pick up the first down, and that's very demoralizing for a defense.
First and 10 now for the 25. That's Marcus Washington again. Just inside the 20. He'll mark it actually right about the 20-yard line.
So Brandon Holmes, number 72, 6'3", 280-pound sophomore, center. Just pushing the pile and moving forward. And Marcus Washington hit the pole with a little bit of purpose. Averaging 4 yards a rush.
Well, you look at the schedules, Jay. I mean, this is a football team coming off a bye week, so they get that extra time to, you know, work on things and heal up after the first few ball games, and, you know, add a few wrinkles perhaps to your offense. And so far, they're getting results here this afternoon. Pass is incomplete. Pass was intended for Dalton Hilliard Jr., I should say. And clock stops now with 7:34 to go first half.
Yeah, Randy, on that play, Toscani Figueroa does a fantastic job of breaking containment. Brian Joseph comes in, and he really does not take a good angle. Figueroa outflanks him very easily, and he's got a lot of room and a lot of time, and he really lets that ball sail a little too high. Hilliard Jr. not even come up with it, but here's the thing. As Toscani gets more of these reps and more of these types of plays, when he sees himself with that much grass, no defenders in front of him, he's going to have a better idea how to put the touch and the pace on the ball.
Third down play. Pass is caught. Kerry Fortson with the catch near the 10-yard line. And again, another first down for this Colonels offense. Well, pressure coming. He got the pass off.
You're right about that. And in this, keep in mind, this is on third down. And you see the poise of Figueroa. He backs up, and you see the respect that this Demons defense has to have to make sure that they're rushing him in and staying in their lanes because he's so athletic. He's really got him a little bit befuddled right now. The defense is on their heels, and Colonels offense is humming.
The 11-yard line. First and 10 now for Nicholls. 7-minute mark. First half. Washington. Tough yards up the middle.
Well, I tell you, we have seen several times now number 46, Ruskus Clare, doing a great job of lead blocking, going in and taking on those linebackers, opening up that seam, and Washington hits the hole with a full head of steam and able to pick up good positive yards.
And number 71 right on the screen there, that's Abasi Salimo. He's your left tackle. He's having a good start today as well, creating some open running room there for Washington. There's Washington again. He's going to be met and brought down by a few demons, and leading the charge there was Pat Black again, number 7. A lot of work today so far for Marcus Washington.
Well, and you see a big package coming in. Gisclair going back into the game, Randy. And when you take a look at him, he's 5'7", all right, 220 pounds from Cutoff, Louisiana. Cutoff, you know where Cutoff is. That's by the bypass.
There you go.
All right.
All right, timeout. Nicholls will talk it over here. 5:44 to go, 13-0, Colonels on top.
The State Farm Southland Conference Mascot Challenge is back. This year's field is bigger and stronger. Willie the Wildcat, Bruce D-Bear, Mingo the Husky, Red the Cardinal, Big Red the Cardinal, Rowdy the Cowboy, Lafitte the Instigator, Colonel Talou, Vic the Demon, Eli the Eagle, Rumi the Lion, the Lumberjack, Izzy the Islander, and defending champion Sammy the Bearcat. $5,000 is on the line. Vote for your favorite on the Southland Conference Facebook page.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'm on it. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
You're covered, Kevin.
Thanks, Melinda.
Wait, I have blah blah insurance, so person, come help.
Hey, Grandma.
Six callers ahead of us, Jimmy.
You're not helping.
Having insurance isn't the same as having State Farm. There to help you anytime, anywhere, any way. That's getting to a better state.
Contact your local State Farm agent.
Welcome back to Thibodeau. Tell you about the SLC mobile app. If you want scores, if you want news, how about video? We got all kinds of stuff on it. Available for iPhone, iPad, and Android users. Check it out there. Cool stuff. You don't want to miss it. The SLC mobile app. Third down play now. Third and two from the 3-yard line. Nicholls knocking on the door once again. Under 6 minutes to go here, first half. And the Colonels have dominated this football game, leading 13-0.
Yeah, they have. You see, Figueroa lost his helmet, Randy, on the play. Has to come out. So we will see Bo Hebert check in. But that Demons defense fighting hard, see if they can keep the Colonels to a hold them to a field goal try. Big third down coming up. They can still get a first down if they get inside the 2-yard line.
Bo Hebert, who's of course like Dalton Hilliard, his dad Bobby Hebert,
when it comes to
NFL player.
Yes, great player, quarterback, Northwestern State. Coach Stubbs is trying to get the play clock. Keep it.
He'll take a timeout. 5:03 to go here, first half. It has been all Colonels of Nicholls. We'll break with them second quarter here at Thibodeau.
So I got this new family, and I don't know what it is about this one, but she can't seem to put down that toy all day long. Tap, 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 tap. Oh, and she even talks to it. She talks to that more than she talks to him. What's up, bro? My shirt. Who's she talking to? Her mom? She talks to her mom a lot.
A single ember from a wildfire can travel over a mile. That ember can ignite and destroy your home or community. You can't control where that ember will land. Only what happens before it does. Visit fireadapted.org to learn how you can help protect your community from wildfires.
Being a dad can be tough.
No, no, no. What do you mean she's not coming?
When's the fairy princess coming?
Any minute now.
But when you're willing to do anything...
It is I, Groove's Zinkelbell. Okay, time for cake.
It's always worth it.
I know it's really you, Groove. I'm just pretending for the other kids.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today. Call 877-4-DAD-411 or visit fatherhood.gov.
Back in Thibodaux, Louisiana, second quarter. Nicholls leading Northwestern State 13-0. Right now, we'll toss it down to the sidelines, check in with Aaron Cofield with an update. Aaron?
Well, as we near halftime, just wanted to share a little bit of what's on the Mid-South Bank Halftime Report. We'll take you to the Digital Network Studio. We'll also speak with the Nicholls State University Athletic Director. Plus, we've got a feature story on one of the coaches here for Nicholls. You don't want to miss it on the Mid-South Bank Halftime Report.
All right, Aaron, thank you very much. All the highlights and score updates as well. So they called the timeout on that play. So Scotty Figueroa can re-enter the football game.
Well, it's a big play. It's fourth down and one near the goal line, and Figueroa carries the ball. Randy, not gonna get into the end zone, but they're saying it's okay. Here we go.
Yeah, it's the Demons are celebrating.
Held him out of the goal line.
Leslie Deemer had some contact. He's running off the field.
Well, the official, Randy, pointed the wrong way. But this is a first down. I said all you got to do is get inside that 2-yard line, which Figueroa did on fourth.
Well, Deemer was thinking it was.
Well, they definitely stopped him short of getting into the end zone. But yeah, it's fourth and one and a half yards, and that's why Coach Stubbs used that timeout, because he wanted to have the run option with Figueroa. So he burns a timeout, picks up the fourth down. Now he's got a first and goal inside the 1-yard line. And that's Coach Stubbs riding the hot hand.
Colonels hand it to Washington. He's in for the touchdown. Colonels strike again here in Thibodaux.
You know, Randy, when everything's going right, and then when it rains, it pours. So you see the both sides of this equation right now. But so far, the Cardinals have been hitting on all cylinders, save that one missed extra point on the first touchdown. But Charlie Stubbs electing to use a timeout on fourth and short so that he could have Figueroa re-enter the game. Figueroa picks up a yard and a half, which is enough for a first down that puts the ball in the line of scrimmage inside the 1-yard line. And on the next play, Marcus Washington scores a touchdown.
All right, let's take a look at some of the folks getting it done in the classroom as well. We call it the Justin's Classroom Champion. Northwestern State tight end Tucker Nims, majoring in history, pre-law concentration, pre-law honor society member. Student Athlete Advisory Council, played baseball last spring as well. He's a first baseman, Tucker Nims, a Justin's Classroom Champion representing Northwestern State. Congratulations to him. 4:39 to go here. You're looking at the scoreboard. You might say, okay, we got a little shocker brewing in Thibodaux, but Nicholls has come to play today. And nothing going so far for the Demons.
On the Demons, Randy, they stayed down in New Orleans last night, so they're not road weary from the bus ride. They were here last night, stayed down at the hotel just outside the airport. And Egan, hang on to that. Yeah, boy, smart.
He thought about it.
Yeah, he did. All great returners think about it.
Yeah, I was going to say, I've never seen one done. All right, let's take a look at another Johnson's Classroom Champions from Nicholls. Representing the Colonels, senior defensive back Jordan Hanbury, 4.0 GPA, biology major, two-time Southland Conference All-Academic selection, back-to-back winner of the Nicholls Student Athlete Award for Academic Excellence. Congratulations to Jordan Hanbury, our Johnson's Classroom Champion, representing.
But it feels
the Colonels
like
from Nicholls.
Jordan and Josh Hanbury have been playing here for 15 years, doesn't it? young men started playing and getting significant playing time as freshmen and have continued on to their senior year and continuing to contribute.
Important series now coming up for Northwestern State, Shea. When you look at what's happened so far in this first half, you've got to get some kind of points here.
Well, Ed Egan does a great job of catching the ball, Randy, and then a pretty good run after that catch, but it was down on, again, top of the shoelaces. So Atkins, it's hard on those receivers when you're running the bubble screen and you get the ball that, you know, not in a comfortable area. Well, Jordan Hanbury played that incredibly well, coming up with that safety spot. Got right in front of DeMond Lorenz.
Atkins also took a hit on that play. Good pressure coming up from Nicholls. He hit the turf pretty hard, but they got a third down play coming up now.
Yeah, I think at this point in the game, you really got to find Louis Oye. I mean, number 17, he's a big athletic receiver. Looks like he's going to get man coverage, but the, you know, guys off of him 5 yards. You got to try to have him make a play, and no, a penalty.
False start. Flag goes down. That's going to be pushing that back another 5 yards.
Offense, number 33, 5 yard penalty, third down.
Well, you can't make those kinds of mistakes. Desperately needing to get something going and moving the chains.
Coach Thomas taking some notes. I think he'll have a little bit to talk about at halftime.
Oye is on the hash mark, inside receiver spot.
Third down and 9. They need to get the 35. Well short. Egan with the catch. Good coverage inside the 25. And the Colonels defense will hold again.
Well, Byron Cobb was all over Ed Egan. Good job out of that cornerback spot. Egan does come up with the catch, picks up about 5 yards, but Byron Cobb right there for a sure open field tackle. And DeMond Bolt going back deep again for the Colonels. Looking like they're going to have good field position.
Yeah, he's right around the 39-yard line. So with just over three minutes left in this first half, good opportunity once again coming up for Nicholls. One bounce. Bolt gets it. Has some space at the middle near the 45-yard line. He's tripped up, and that's where Nicholls will take over on offense.
Well, it's a dangerous proposition, Randy, the way that you see DeMond Bolt playing that ball. He is playing the hop. So on the rugby-style kick, he's expecting that ball to bounce forwards towards him, and he gets a perfect bounce on that one. He returns it up to the 45-yard line.
Take a look at the Nicholls' schedule from this season. They open at Oregon. That was a tough loss. Kind of a wake-up call. You're going playing against one of the nation's top programs. But then this is something that built confidence, Shea, at Western Michigan, FBS team. And they get away there with a victory, 27-23. And, you know, you make progress. You take steps. That was certainly one that this program needed. They got it done at Western Michigan. Trying to get it in conference play as well. Deep ball is caught from Figueroa. That's a touchdown for Nicholls, and Eric Buchanan with the honors for the Colonels.
I'll tell you what, Randy, you see some of the offensive linemen celebrating as much as anyone else, as they should. Look at the time that Toscani Figueroa has in the backfield. He's got man coverage downfield, and there's no way a defensive back can run with the wide receiver when a quarterback has forever and a day to get rid of it. Eric Buchanan just finally works his way open down the middle of the field. And that was a fairly easy pitching catch. But that offensive front for the Colonels did an outstanding job of giving Toscani Figueroa all the time in the world.
27-0. Nicholls completely dominating Northwestern State here in the first half. Take another look at this from Toscani Figueroa to Eric Buchanan.
Well, look at the big guys up front, giving them all that time. And you see you've got your defender out on an island trying to run with the wide receiver. And, I mean, that's just not a fair fight.
Update the scoreboard from around the Southland Conference. Let's check in on some of the games going on today and tonight. We showed you earlier. Let's update it now in the third quarter in Huntsville. Sam Houston State, number 2 in the nation, Yeah. And all they can handle and then some for the Lamar Cardinals, only leading 14-3.
And I'm guessing Bill Bradley's defense for the Cardinals doing a great job stepping up and holding one of the most potent offenses in the FCS division.
And Central Arkansas on top, Nebraska Kearney 10-0. There's Buchanan, 5 catches, 136 yards on the season. That's a big one right there as they find the end zone again. Ed Egan, a few yards back, he'll bring it out for Northwestern State, looking for some kind of spark. He's tripped up around the 15-yard line, falls forward. And Northwestern State with 2:40 to go, Shea, down 27-0. Tempers flare a little bit around the 20-yard line. A little frustration beginning to mount now for the Demons.
It's been a dominant performance by the Colonels so far in the first half, Randy. I mean, really, just again, they're doing everything and getting everything out of their offense that Coach Stubbs talked about. And really, what has not worked for the Colonels? Nothing. Everything's worked. I mean, the play action pass has been good. The run game has been good. The short to intermediate passing game has been good. Offensive front is doing a great job. Their defense is also helping them. They've given them a couple of three and outs here recently, and they've made it very tough sledding for the Demons offense. You keep turning that ball back over, starts to wear the other defense out.
TJ Lumar with a big stop there, number 36. Clock continues to roll now. 2:21 and counting here, first half.
Late flag.
Hand off. That's
Atzenweiler. Yeah, it's a good run. Good power run right there. Let's see what the flag is, Randy.
Well, what kind of confidence builder can this be?
Illegal formation. Often. More than four men in the backfield. 5-yard penalty.
And Atzenweiler had, that was a good physical run. That was going to be a pickup of about 5 or 6 yards. It's going to be 3rd and 1, 3rd and 2. Now after the penalty, it's going back to 2nd and 12.
Second down and 7 now. They'll mark it at the 16-yard line. Atkins downfield looking for Ollier. I think that's Lumar again on the coverage, was it? Around the 50?
TJ Lumar comes up huge. Oye had a step on him, Randy. Had a step. Lumar closes very well and gets right in. Take a look here in the replay. See Atkins there. He lays it out over the top. He sees Oye behind him. You see that right hand at the very last second. Lumar comes in, flicks the ball away. Big third down.
Flag on the play.
Ooh, what a grab.
Yeah, pass is caught over there. We had flags flying.
It looks like a free play because you didn't hear a whistle. That means offsides on the defense, most likely.
Ryan Mitchell on the reception there for Northwestern State.
This is decision time now for Jay Thomas because I believe it is going to be offsides on the defense. But the catch by Mitchell, Randy, if they take the play, it's going to be 4th and short. They're going to decline it, I would guess.
Defense, number 89, 5-yard penalty. We'll replay 3rd down.
Wow, okay. Look where the ball is marked. The ball is marked at the 28-yard line, so it'd be 4th and 1, 1.5 yards. Instead, now they're going to take the penalty, so it'll remain 3rd down, but now you're talking about 3rd and almost 9 yards.
Need to get to the 28-yard line to move the chains here. Atkins looking. Boy, that's Brian Mitchell. Mitchell's could use a couple more inches there to go up the stairs and get that one.
Yeah, that ball sailed on Atkins just a little bit. He completes 64% of his passes, but just got a little bit too much air underneath that one. Brian Mitchell not able to climb the ladder enough to come down, and Damon Bolt standing on his own 45-yard line. Waiting to field the punt. And let's see, Randy, if he plays this again where he allows the ball to hit the ground and then roll, because he's playing a forward bounce off the rugby-style kick. Yep, he's giving himself some room, but this one checks up. gets down.
49-yard line, and all of a sudden, now you got plenty of time here, Shea. You got a minute 34 the way Nicholls has been moving the football, putting points up. This is exactly how they would want to draw it up. All right, let's take a look at the schedule now. We gave you the current games going on right now, but tonight we've got a couple of more on ESPN3, 7 o'clock kickoff. Just down the road from here, what, a couple hours?
In Hammond.
Stephen F. Austin in Hammond taking on Southeastern. That should be a good matchup. Also tonight at 7:30 in
Love
Houston.
Love that matchup. Love that matchup.
Stephen F. And,
no, Abilene.
Oh, Abilene Christian and Houston Baptist.
You bet.
That's right. Future Southland Conference rivals, perhaps. They meet in downtown Houston today. Figueroa upstairs. And that'll be incomplete around the 10-yard line. All right, back now, if we can, to looking at, towards the future here, Shea. 2014, you mentioned Abilene Christian and HBU. University of Incarnate Word as well. It's going to be a good conference with the new addition.
Well, in Abilene Christian, it's what's new again, or what's old again is new again. I'm not sure how to say that, but an original member of the Southland Conference back in 1963, five teams. Abilene Christian was one of them. Back in the conference, and then, as you said, Houston Baptist and University of Incarnate Word. Larry Keenan doing a good job down there in San Antonio. And hey, it's exciting times for the Southland Conference.
Figueroa brought down. Clock will continue to roll around the 47-yard line. Approaching the one-minute mark here. Burt White with the stop.
We saw the Colonels offense, Randy, on first down with this fantastic field position, as you said, you know, plenty of time on the clock. Take a shot down deep for Josh Hanberry. Incomplete pass, and then on second down, this Demons defense stiffens just a little bit. Hold Figueroa to a short gain, so now it's third and nine.
Well, they've really done it. I think Nicholls has done a great job of just clock management today. I mean, they're not rushing. They're just taking their time. They're staying relaxed. Putting together good, solid drives so far in this first half. Figueroa had an open man around the 20-yard line. That was Darrell Watson again. He had a lot of space there around the 20, just overthrew him.
Well, Watson had outflanked his defender and was running open, but Figueroa got a little bit of pressure, Randy, and he just didn't have quite enough time and didn't put enough air underneath that ball. But I like the aggressive play calling. I mean, you know, this is one of the things, and you say, look, you're up 27 to nothing. You're getting close to the half. Why not just take a knee and go in? The Colonels need this type of game. They need confidence. They need to execute and continue. They can't take a break on anybody because, as you said earlier, last 2 years in conference, they've not won a Southland game. But these guys have to learn how to win and learn how to finish games.
Baby steps. Ed Egan, fair catch. So Northwestern State's going to be buried deep. So you got 27 seconds left. You're already down at this point, 27 to nothing. You avoid any potential turnover, just take a knee, head inside, and let's try to figure this thing out.
Yeah, I think that's probably the prudent call right now. And certainly it's been difficult to get anything going on offense, and you don't want Zach Atkins out there running around trying to buy a little bit of extra time to get a receiver downfield. And lined up in the shotgun, though. He's not, looks like they're actually going to see what they can do. Well, just a little handoff up the middle.
It might be the final play of the.
Well, Atkins looks like he's trying to hurry the Demons offense back out, Randy. See if he can snag another play out of this.
Taylor's first carry of the football game. Atkins will hold on to this one around the 20, knocked out of bounds around the 18.
He's going to have a couple. He's got another play. He bounced out of bounds, stopped the clock with 4 seconds left.
A little surprised they're running some plays here. When you've been pounded in the first half, why not take a knee and just go try to figure things out? But they're holding on to it right now. This will be the last play of the, likely last play of the first half. And that's going to be Taylor at the 25-yard line. And that will do it. Zeros on the clock here at Thibodeau. A complete domination by the Colonels of Nicholls. An impressive day so far as they look to win their first conference game in 2 years. A lot of halftime activities coming up right now. Let's toss it down to the field. Let's check in with Eric Cofield standing by with Coach Stubbs.
Coach, you had the option of going with Bo Hebert or Toscani Figueroa. You went with Figueroa. He's done a great job. Your thoughts on his performance so far?
Well, I'm just glad I've got some capable guys, but Toscani's executing the offense real well. He does a lot with his feet, too, as a very good athlete. He's making some nice throws, and it is kind of breezy down here, so sometimes a few of them got a little high on him, but again, I'm pleased with his performance thus far.
Are you more impressed with the 27 points your offense has put up or the zero that your defense has held them?
I am proud of the defense more than I am, because that's what it's going to take for us to win games and win conference games in this league.
All right, thanks so much.
You're welcome.
Guys?
All right, Aaron, appreciate it. The Colonels will go in to talk it over, so will the Demons from Northwestern State. Halftime activities coming up. A lot to get to. We have all kinds of highlights and interviews. Coming up on the Mid-South Bank Halftime Show, 27-0. Nicholls leading Northwestern State at the half here in Thibodaux.
So what we've been working for since last year. Winning, that's the most important thing. It takes a lot of hours, it takes a lot of commitment.
Every season starts with the same goal. It's the goal of every team. It's the reason each week they give everything they've got. Each team strives to make their dream a reality. The dream, become the very best in college football. But only one team will earn the ultimate title, NCAA National Champions.
What a great atmosphere.
The energy here is electrifying. Ball leveled at the 24. Caught for a touchdown. That ball's intercepted. FCS National Championship game. My, oh my.
And let the party begin.
And the best way to see it is to experience it live. The 2014 NCAA Division I Football Championship game. Game day begins outside the stadium at Tailgate Town, a free event where college football fans and families get in on all the action. Test your skills, meet the stars of the game, and enjoy the pregame party as the anticipation to kickoff builds. From the moment the players arrive at the stadium to the postgame championship award ceremony.
Thank you to the best fans in America!
You can be part of history, cheering on the nation's best. The 2014 NCAA Division I Football Championship Game. Saturday, January 4th at FC Dallas Stadium in Frisco, Texas. Affordable tickets available. Go online at ncaa.com/FCS and reserve your seats today. Make a date with champions and experience it live.
At Mid-South Bank, we're dedicated to providing loans that allow our customers to achieve their business and personal dreams. That's one promise you can bank on. We're not just business associates, we're neighbors. We're committed to our customers and the strength of our local economy. Here at Mid-South Bank, responsibility matters. With over 61 locations and still growing in Louisiana and Texas, discover how our customers are finding strength in numbers at Mid-South Bank.
This is the Mid-South Bank Halftime Report on the Southland Conference Television Network. We've reached the break in Thibodaux between Northwestern State and Nicholls. We'll get you back to Guidry Stadium for more from Randy, Shay, and Aaron in just a few minutes. Hey everyone, I'm Megan Clemente, and welcome to the Southland Digital Network Studios. After just a single league game last week, every other football team gets into conference play this weekend. Also, the competitive balance is really showing in soccer, and in volleyball, the list of unbeatens is down to two. Southeastern Louisiana hosts Stephen F. Austin in an ESPN3 primetime matchup. The Lions are coming off a big win over UIW and are 3-2 on the season. The only losses are to ranked teams, TCU in FBS and South Dakota State in FCS. Meanwhile, SFA is coming off a game 2 weeks ago in which Brady Attaway passed for a Southland record 662 yards. Aaron Thomas had a school record 242 yards receiving. But the Lumberjacks lost a high-scoring contest to Prairie View A&M. Coverage begins at 7 o'clock live from Strawberry Stadium.
McNeese State has vaulted to the number 9 spot in the Sports Network rankings thanks to a big win in the Red Beans and Rice Bowl last weekend over Central Arkansas. The Cowboys have a bye Saturday, and it comes just at the right time as they now have an extra week to prepare for a showdown next Saturday versus Sam Houston State in Lake Charles.
And I think this team competes hard, and of course, and we know what Sam's about. So, you know, hopefully, but we need some time off, no question about it. And, you know, and in a couple of weeks, we look forward to the game.
In volleyball, Sam Houston State and Central Arkansas still have undefeated conference marks. However, there is no breathing room as there are 3 more teams with just a single loss. SHSU moved to 6-0 as it beat Lamar last Saturday. The Cardinals did become the first Southland team to take a set from the Bearcats, but it wasn't enough as SHSU still wins 3-1. That's the 7th win in the last 9 contests for the Bearcats. With a pair of victories this past week, UCA pulls into a tie for the league lead with SHSU. The Sugar Bears beat Northwestern State 3-1 and then shut out Stephen F. Austin 3-0. Heather Schnars had quite an afternoon versus SFA. She had 16 kills, 7 digs, 3 blocks, and 2 aces. It only took 3 weeks of Southland play to show the parity in soccer. Southeastern Louisiana, Stephen F. Austin, and Oral Roberts all have identical 4-1 records. Central Arkansas is right there as well, just a half a game back with a 3-1 mark. SFA is rolling. The Lady Jacks shut out Houston Baptist last Friday and then won their 4th in a row on Sunday by beating Sam Houston State 1-0 in overtime. Southeastern Louisiana hosted Lamar in its only contest of the week. Katie Noonan scored 49 seconds into the match to set the tone. The Lions won 3-1 to earn their share of the top spot. As you can see from this week's highlights, the depth of the Southland is beginning to show. Nobody is running away with the championship, and now the competition gets even more intense. I'm Megan Clemente. Thanks for joining me on the Mid-South Bank Halftime Report. Next up, we'll head back to Thibodaux as we get set for the second half of the NSU Challenge. Stay tuned for more of the Demons and Colonels on over 25 affiliates across the Southland Conference Television Network.
Think of the NCAA as a spirit squad, cheering for student athletes at every big event and every small one. We'd be there in the classroom, at graduation, at their first job interview. Okay, so don't think of us as a spirit squad. Think of us as a mascot. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes.
It's 27-0 at halftime on the Southland Conference Game of the Week. It has been all Nicholls so far in this ball game. This is the Mid-South Bank Halftime Report. Well, just a few weeks here at Nicholls, they inducted the 2013 class into their Athletics Hall of Fame. One person in that class was student assistant coach Greg Greeley. Greeley is someone who knows firsthand that it is never too late to go back and get your undergrad degree. Amanda Kelly has his story.
Greeley started at Nicholls in the early 80s, twice earning All-Louisiana honors. He departed the program as the all-time school leader with 21 interceptions before embarking on a pro career.
After my senior year here at Nicholls State in 1984, I was drafted by the United States Football League, San Antonio Gunslingers, 24th player overall, the 2nd round. I had a brief stint with them. That didn't work out as well as I was hoping it to work out. And then I came and signed a free agent contract with the New Orleans Saints. But before that, I had some trials with the Houston Oilers and the Green Bay Packers as well.
Greeley's focus at that time was clearly on football, as his coursework took a back seat. After his pro career ended, Greeley spent several decades working in the private sector. After all those years away from Nicholls, Greeley decided it was time to come home and finish what he started. But after arriving back on campus, he couldn't get his mind off the game and sought to help out the Colonels football team any way he could.
Well, here's the thing. When I got back, I had reached out to Coach Stubbs, and then Coach Stubbs reached right back out to me. He brought me in. He sat down. He talked with me. He got a little chance to know me a little bit, and I expressed interest in working with the football program. And Coach Stubbs was a great person. He stood there, and he said, well, Greg, look, I can get you in. I can have you to do things with the program to maybe encourage the guys and give them some life experience talks. So it worked out for me.
Greeley's help is much appreciated by the coaches and players alike.
Well, he's a great role model, first of all. That's the way I looked at it first, because I admire a person, especially at our age. You know, he's not as old as I am, but, you know, he could have very easily just kind of gave up the ghost on his academics, because the real story is, of course, he was an excellent football player here at Nicholls in the past and put all his eggs in one basket. You know, he just wanted to be an NFL player or Canadian football player, and it just didn't work out. And then he went on and just in life, and he got back and he said, well, shoot, I'm going to go back and finish my degree, and I admire it because many people wouldn't do it. And I think it's a great testament to him, but also now he's got, it's a living example right there for our kids.
Greeley's on-field accomplishments certainly warranted a place in the Nicholls Athletics Hall of Fame, but it's been Greeley's personal journey back to education and service that ensured his induction. Though Greeley has only 15 more hours to complete before earning his degree, the hope is to see him around for longer as he plans a full-time coaching career. His legacy is now cemented forever at Nicholls. His records may someday be broken, but his energy and leadership is inspiring a new generation of colonels.
Thanks, Amanda. Let's now go up to the press box where Randy is standing by with a special guest. Randy?
All right, Aaron, thank you very much. Rob Bernardi, the athletics director here at Nicholls, and good to see you and good to catch up a little bit. You and I were talking just about all the things, all the great things going on. But first, you've been around, you're going on your 13th year here as AD. You've seen a lot of things happen around
here. Well, I have, and let me say, I'm in second to the Northwestern AD. Greg's been here about 17 years. So, yeah, I've been here at Nicholls 13 years, and Greg and I are kind of the senior members of the Southland Conference.
A lot of changes coming up, some new additions to the conference, one of which is UNO, University of New Orleans. Talk about the impact that can have on a rivalry between that program and here at Nicholls.
Well, what's great about the addition of UNO, they're the fifth now Louisiana school. And, you know, if you look back, Randy, on the tradition of conferences, conferences were like institutions from a like geographic area. So now with five Louisiana schools and some Texas schools, we are, you know, what conferences are all about. And that is traditional rivals based on location of institutions. So it's great to have UNO. Of course, they don't play football, but we'll have some great rivalries that are really already exist in some of our other sports.
How about this football program? Just a couple of quick hits. I want to ask you about some others as well, but 27-0 today. You had a win over an FBS team, Western Michigan. What did that mean for this program to get a victory like that?
Well, you know, after that week, Randy, just the confidence that it brought in those kids. In just a week's time, they went from, you know, kind of struggling a little bit, having gotten beat pretty good by Lafayette and, of course, playing University of Oregon, then to go on the road and play a team like Western Michigan, which, you know, probably weren't supposed to win, but they went up there and played really well, and more than anything else, they developed confidence, and I think it's demonstrated here tonight.
Final 30 seconds or so off the field, other activities here around the university. I know there's a culinary program, a culinary school. I know they are proud of.
You know, Nicholls is unique in a lot of ways, our culture, where we're located. But one of the things that we have is a culinary institute, and we have kids come across all across the United States to come to our culinary school. We're building a new facility, so we're able to expand the number of students we can handle, And it's something that makes Nicholls really unique and a place where people really want to come if you have an interest in getting into that kind of industry.
All right, good things happening here. Robert Arney, the longtime AD here at Nicholls. Go enjoy the second half. Right now, things are looking good for the Colonel.
It really is. Thanks.
Very good. Appreciate the time. All right, our halftime show continues here from Thibodeau. It has been all Nicholls, 27-0. How about that score here at home for the Colonels over Northwestern State? A lot in store, though. A lot of football left here at Thibodeau. More coming up when we come back.
Read to a child today and spark a lifetime of ambition.
But it would be safe to keep your distance until there are secrets that make you smile.
I have the sources say that chicken soup has proven
has found their way out of the secret.
Getting closer to nature can get you closer to your family. Go to discovertheforest.org.
Thibodeau, Louisiana, 27-0, Nicholls leading Northwestern State. Mid-South Bank halftime show continues. Both teams back on the field. We'll get going here momentarily. Let's take a look at some of the stats here, Shay, from the first half. And total offense. How about that Nicholls defense holding Northwestern State to only 79 yards?
Well, they've done a great job defensively, and you heard Coach Stubbs tell Aaron Cofield on his way in that defense wins championships. But offensively, hey, 27 points on the board. It's a good combined team effort.
Take a look at some of the highlights from the first half, mainly all Nicholls. There's one play, though, the stop there by Simon on Toscani Figueroa. Yeah, the defense making a few stops there, but not enough, not nearly enough for the Demons, because a lot of offense today from Nicholls. Toscani Figueroa, touchdown there to DeMond Bolt.
Yeah, big offensive line creating lanes for Marcus Washington. Been a very efficient rusher. And then again, offensive line, Randy, has just been outstanding, allowing Figueroa all kinds of time. As he looks down, he finds Eric Buchanan there for the long pitching catch for a touchdown.
That's the way it stands right now, 27-0. Nicholls 3-2, looking for win number four, but more importantly, 1-0 in conference. If they can get this victory, they haven't won in 2 years in the Southland Conference, so they want that drought to end today.
You definitely don't want to put the cart before the horse, and I know Coach Stubbs would say that as well. But, Randy, what you have to do is keep executing your offense, keep playing your defense like you've been playing, and it has been a sweltering defense. They forced a lot of three and outs, and they've been giving the offense a lot of good field position, and that's what's helped get this 27-0 lead on the board.
Well, it's been informed that both teams are out, and Northwestern State's offensive coordinator has left the booth. He's going down to the sideline, see if they can
muster up some offense.
Yeah, get something rolling down there, prove the communication. We're going to find out here. Second half, will begin momentarily. We'll take one last break. We're coming back to Thibodeau. Colonels leading 27-0.
We are Louisiana's future.
We are regionally ranked.
We are nationally accredited.
We are progressive.
We are passionate.
We are purple.
We are global.
We are local.
We are
Northwestern State University.
Local.
Global.
Northwestern State.
The game of the week on the Southland Conference Television Network, brought to you by Mid-South Bank, the official bank of the Southland Conference. It's time to love your bank. By State Farm, visit texas.statefarm.com for your chance to win the ultimate VIP experience. And let State Farm help you get to a better state. And by Jostens, the official championship ring provider of the Southland Conference. Jostens, the ring of champions. Back live at Guidry Stadium in Thibodeau, ready for the second half of action between Nicholls and Northwestern State. If you're just tuning in, it was all Colonels in the first half, dominating Northwestern State 27-0. The Demons back to receive to open the second half. Andrew Dolan with the honors. Ed Egan, about 10 yards back in the end zone. He'll take a knee, and Northwestern State.
Oh, Randy.
There's a couple of flags down over at the 20 as well.
Some jawing and some late stuff going on. Hard to tell, but you see the Northwestern State Demons looking positively at that.
CJ Appleby coming off the field there for Nicholls. Let's listen in here.
After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct, kicking team, number 24. That's his first unsportsmanlike foul of the game.
Right now, let's toss it down to Aaron Cofield for a quick update. Aaron, what's it?
As I spoke with Coach Jay Thomas of Northwestern, I asked him what he told his team at the break. He said he told them that, number one, they're going to learn a lot about themselves right now and how they can handle facing adversity. He said he told his team they can still get back in it. They just need to do the little things, catch the ball, no turnovers.
Big play to open this second half for Northwestern. Another flag, two flags down, as a matter of fact. Big time run there by Daniel Taylor, the sophomore. Big open space there on that offensive line, and he took advantage of it.
Well, Randy, that personal foul put the ball in great starting field position for the Demons offense, and Daniel Taylor just rips right
face
up the middle. Late flag's
defense,
probably going to be a
number 27,
face mask.
Half the distance to goal. First down.
Face mask penalty, yeah. So.
Flags are all the way down there where Daniel Taylor was stopped. Figuring it would be a face mask, but man, you talk about hitting the hole and really not having any second thoughts of where he was going. Averages 4.7 yards a carry, and that was a heck of a run right there. First and goal now for the Demons offense. And Etzenweiler back in the backfield. He's in for the touchdown.
No signal yet. Oh, yeah, we got one now. Touchdown, Demon. Just like that, they have answered the bell to open this second half.
I'll tell you what, if you went to get a cup of coffee or a cold drink from the concession stand, you better get back quick.
Take a look at this again. Here's the play that got it started, the handoff to Daniel Taylor. The guy's got speed. Look at the hole, and down he goes. Big-time gainer, and couple of penalties against Nicholls and Northwestern State.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, could this be the wake-up call? We'll find out how Nicholls respond.
Yeah, pretty good scoring drive. 23 seconds. Two plays, 23 seconds.
Here's a touchdown run again from high atop the tower. Weiler right there.
Yeah, just see how strong he is, Randy. I mean, everybody knows he's going to get the ball down in those short yardage situations.
All right, let's toss it once again down to the sidelines. Aaron Cofield with more on the contact story. Aaron?
Talking about Daniel Taylor, in one of their games earlier this season against Langston, he'd broken loose for a touchdown. The ball comes his way, and it just bounces at his feet, which was very uncharacteristic. So coach said, you know, what's going on? Why didn't you catch it? And he said, coach, I don't have my contacts. So coach has instituted a rule where not only does he need to speak up, but everybody has got to bring three of everything. So they're packing heavy when they go on the road for Northwestern.
Thanks, Aaron. Yeah, you got to be able to see out there. That always helps.
It is kind of a prerequisite. If you're going to catch the ball, it's always good that you can see it.
All right, there's Garrett Atzenweiler, and Northwestern State is on the board. And I'm sure it was an interesting halftime conversation. Down 27. They get the personal foul on Nicholls and the face mask penalty as well. Man, it did not take long at all to get on the board and get some confidence going here. Nicholls will bring it out. That is a DeMond Bolt for the Colonels.
He definitely made it interesting.
Yeah,
didn't field it cleanly.
Second time he's done that today. But he got his hands back on it, and they hold on to the football. So we'll see what they could do now on offense. A terrific first half for this Colonels offense.
Well, they just had everything going really so well, Randy. We talk about that offensive front with Salimu, Plaisance Holmes, Caleb Klein, and Eric Alt just doing a great job up front. And then number 46, he doesn't get a lot of accolades, a lot of carries, a lot of touches, but Russ Gisclair's done a great job of blocking, sealing off linebackers, and he's been a very important component of the success for the Colonels offense.
Dalton Hilliard Jr.
Pat Black from that linebacker spot. Man,
that's some contact up here. We heard that one.
Yeah, Hilliard looked, Randy, like he had a lot of room to run. And he was just going full speed, and all of a sudden just stopped. And you see Pat Black emerge from the pile.
Here's Hilliard again, and yeah, you're right. Pat Black is right there to greet him. He is fired up out there, senior from Jackson, Mississippi. Second down and 8 now. They'll mark it at the 22. Hand off, it's Marcus Washington. And nothing going there up the middle. So this Demons defense is kind of following up the offense. You know, you get this team riled up and get them some confidence out there. A couple of quick strikes and they're back in this football game.
Well, the front three there, Deion Simon and Leslie Deemer. Keelan Johnson really doing a great job of just plugging up the running lane. And I can say what, Marcus Washington also doing a fine job of just pushing the pile a little bit. Third and right at 6 yards to go for the first down.
Figueroa, nothing there. He'll scramble. He's got a little running room. Crosses a 30, 35. He'll mark it at the 38-yard line there.
Yeah, just an incredible athletic play by Toscani Figueroa. He doesn't have the downfield coverage is good. Doesn't have a wide receiver. He goes through the progression. He checks it twice. Then he starts running in the middle. And then he bounces it back out to the left side. And that throws the defense completely off. Even though that the defenders were in their rush lanes, Figueroa had enough athleticism to get to the outside and pick up a first down. And, man, you couldn't play it any better defensively. You just can't account for Toscani Figueroa and the way that he runs the ball.
Figueroa kicked it out to Dillion. Ball's loose.
Out. I think Hilliard got back on it, Randy.
Yeah, I think he jumped back on it for just a moment there. Looked like Pat Black might get in there, but Hilliard will recover for Nicholls. Knocking the ball loose was Jamarcus Marshall. He got the hand on it.
A few anxious moments over there on the sideline by coaches for the Well, Nicholls still on the Nicholls staff.
As much as you build up as they did in the first half, it could fall apart just like that with a bunch of silly penalties and turnovers, and they mount quickly. This Northwestern State team can rally back in a hurry.
Well, Figueroa elected to go under center on that play. And how about the catch by Marcus Washington? Randy coming in, 22 catches, leads all receivers by a ton. Comes up with a huge grab. Not a very good throw by Figueroa. Take a look at Washington, stick the right paw up. Kind of manage that one-handed. There you go.
Not a problem at all, was it?
That's a big conversion.
Look at that concentration. Well done by Washington. First down and 10 now for Nicholls. Back in Demon territory. They'll mark it here at the 43-yard line. Trying to answer the touchdown by Northwestern State to open this second half.
Hillier doing a good job there, cutting that back up against the grain, running through a couple of arm tackles. A little bit more confidence there when you see you picking up 5 yards on first down.
Right now, let's toss it down to the sidelines and check in injury update from Aaron. Aaron, what do you have?
Well, guys, we haven't seen much of Colonel starting tight end Nick South, though, because he actually tweaked his ankle in the first half. At halftime, they reevaluated it. They determined it is a sprained ankle. He is still dressed on the sideline with helmet in hand, but I'm told it's questionable whether or not he'll be back in this ballgame.
All right, Aaron, thank you very much. Junior, 6'4", 235-pounder. They need him out there, but you know what? They've been productive today. Oh, there's a big hit at the 40-yard line. Figueroa with the keeper.
They got hit from the front side and the back side. Cordarius Golston is dragging him down from the back. And then you take a look. He's going to take another shot as he gets over. There's Golston. And then it's another
Tyler
shot.
Tyler Smith.
Tyler Smith, linebacker.
Yep.
That's kind of, and usually Figueroa, he's a big guy. 6'3", 210 pounds. He's strong. We've seen him run the ball. And he looks big out there on the field, Randy, but you don't want your quarterback taking too many of those kind of shots.
Play clock just about at zero, so Nicholls continues to do what they did in the first half, really milk this clock. Figueroa, little underthrown ball, but Bolt came back to get that one here at the 20-yard line. He anticipated well on that one.
Well, he did, and they're getting man coverage. Blitz is coming from the Demons defense, so they've got man coverage in the back. And really, Figueroa does a great job. Holds his poise. Like the way he stands in the pocket. He just finds Bolt. And he just throws the ball to a space that he knows DeMond can run underneath it and catch it. Jermaine Walker there on the coverage, Randy. But I tell you, Figueroa has got this offense. He's very comfortable with it, obviously, and making some big plays for him.
First and 10 now from the 19-yard line.
I tell you this, on this particular drive, this Demons defense is making the Colonels offense earn every yard. Now they're coming up with some big plays. We saw the great catch by Marcus Washington. DeMond Bolt making a couple of good grabs there. Figueroa making good throws. But it's not coming easy.
How important is it, do you think, for Nicholls here in the second half, knowing what just happened for Northwestern State, to kind of reestablish the momentum here?
Well, I think it's extremely important, and I give the guys up front a lot of credit. Salimu and the others are doing a great job of creating some space and some lanes. There's Figueroa on a designed run. Adam Jones doing a great job closing down and lays a pretty good lick on him. But yeah, that offensive front, Randy, for me, is that's where the tone gets set. Now, how much time does Figueroa have to sit back in the pocket, locate a receiver? When he gets good protection, he's pretty clean back there in the pocket. He's able to step up and deliver the ball. That certainly goes a long way. But here we go again. Third down, first half. In the first half, and I think this would probably be a challenge for the Colonel's offense at any time. They went 7-for-10 on third down.
Pretty
in the first
good
half.
Percentage right there. 3rd and 9 now from the 18. So this is a big play coming up from Nicholls. Overthrown right there. That's by Toscani Figueroa, looking for his receiver. Intended receiver on that play was number 14, Josh Hanberry.
First time today that we have seen the Demons defense able to get to Figueroa. Take a look at Tyler Roussel. He forces that throw early, earlier than Toscani wanted to get rid of it. Now going to force the field goal try.
They'll mark it at the 25-yard line, so about a 35, approaching 36-yard field goal by Andrew Dolan. He is 4 of 8 on the season. And you can make that 4 of 9 wide right by Andrew Dolan. So the Colonels come up empty on this drive. They eat some clock, but they're still well in control of this football game, 27-7 in Thibodaux.
Maybe the light hurts his eyes.
Maybe she's just not hungry. Maybe it's a phase.
Avoiding eye contact is one early sign of autism. Learn the others today.
Some people struggle with their mortgage payments. They become frozen, petrified, not knowing what to do. They do nothing. But the people who do something, the people who take action, are far more likely to get the most positive outcome. Making Home Affordable is a free government program. Call now to talk one-on-one with a housing expert about the options that are right for you. Real help, real answers, right now.
Maybe he's really focused.
Maybe he likes spinning the wheels.
Maybe he just loves trucks.
Preoccupation with objects is one early sign of autism. Learn the others today.
I'm Jay Thomas, head coach at
Northwestern State, and I'm Southland Strong.
All right, welcome back to Thibodaux. 7:33 to go, third quarter, 27-7 lead for Nicholls. That was a drive, a productive drive. They moved it downfield, but you come up with 0 points on that. It's a little disappointing finish there. Zach Atkins back out there. Demons' first drive produced their first touchdown of the afternoon. Daniel Taylor had that big run. He gets the carry right there as well. Taylor coming in, two touchdowns on the season.
Yeah, Chris Berman there on the stop. So he is really an impressive linebacker. That blocked field goal against Arkansas Tech late in the fourth quarter to save the win. Ed Egan there. Oh, nope, don't go back in the fray, my friend. It's dangerous back on the interior. Yeah, he kept bouncing it to the inside. You want him bouncing and working that to the outside. There's a lot of less bodies there.
Ed Egan's a gentleman we spoke up at the top. Punt returner, kickoff returner, but played defense a year ago. And Coach Thomas got back here in charge of his program and knew all about Ed Egan from when he was here as an assistant coach. And so, you know what? The guy's got good hands. Let's put him out there. Pass intended for Louis Ollier. Outstretched arms just off his fingertips around the 35-yard line. Good coverage by that Colonel secondary.
Well, Randy, with 4 yards to go on third down and desperately needing to get something going, trying to find Louis Ollier downfield, but you're not able to come up with that grab, which is kind of it's a little bit of a low percentage throw. Or that you're going to actually make that completion. But now you're forced to punt the ball away on fourth and four. Defense did a good job of holding that Colonel's offense off the board, but now Colonel's defense, quick three and out.
Mont Bolt back for Nicholls.
Well, I got a great roll there. It's exactly, couldn't execute the rugby style kick any better.
Got the yardage, he'll take it. Still good field position coming up. Nicholls gets it at their own 30 here in the third.
At MidSouth Bank, we're dedicated to providing loans that allow our customers to achieve their business and personal dreams. That's one promise you can bank on. We're not just business associates, we're neighbors. We're committed to our customers and the strength of our local economy. Here at MidSouth Bank, responsibility matters. With over 61 locations and still growing in Louisiana and Texas, discover how our customers are finding strength in numbers at MidSouth Bank.
In the NCAA Division I Football Championship Subdivision, the game is played with perseverance, integrity, passion, character, and sportsmanship as he works to honor the game and respect his teammates, opponents, officials, and fans. Every FCS player grows in his responsibilities as a student athlete and as a member of his campus and community. The NCAA Division I Football Championship Subdivision. Every down, every day.
Every down, every day, every team strives to make their dream a reality. The dream, NCAA National Champion.
And let the party begin.
Experience it live at the 2014 NCAA Division I Football Championship Game, Saturday, January 4th at FC Dallas Stadium in Frisco, Texas. Affordable tickets available. Visit ncaa.com/FCS to reserve your seats today.
It's 27-7, Nicholls on top. Vic the Demon visited the Demon Hair Salon this past offseason. He's going purple. He's toned up a little bit. He is looking to win the State Farm Southland Conference Mascot Challenge. He's in 10th place right now. He's trying to impress you. Go vote for him or for any of the mascots in the Southland Conference at facebook.com/Southland Conference.
Now, I think really the question is, Aaron, did he impress you? Colonel Toulouse says he's looking for a little airtime. He didn't want Vic getting all the airtime.
So the Lumberjack was the winner last year, right?
No, it was
Sammy. Sammy won it, but last minute. Sammy made the rally late.
Sammy rallied late, came on. The Lumberjack was in the driver's seat for almost the entire season, but Bearcats came through again, just as their team did, making their second consecutive trip to this national championship game.
You see the mascot challenge information on Facebook, so check it out. Facebook.com/Southland Conference. Big run here. Marcus Washington, he's got room around that left side. And the winner wins $5,000 for the Spirit Group. It's quite an honor right there. That'll go a long way. The Lumberjack thought he might have that title wrapped up, but Sammy the Bearcat and the Bearcat Nation came to play. So your chance to represent your favorite mascot in your school and have fun with it.
Well, it's definitely fun for us. And we've got some we have some new additions into the mascot lineup.
We have the new Cardinal coming in.
Is he?
Ball comes loose again at the 50-yard line. Looks like, a couple of demons said they recovered, but
Look like Margaret Washington got back on top of it, Randy. But this is the second time about this point on the field where we have seen Dalton Hilliard Jr. lost the ball earlier in the first half. Marcus Washington not able to hang on to it there. Take a look as he comes to the line of scrimmage. Runs into his own man. I believe that's what knocks it out. Caleb Klein. You're expecting the other guy to be there, but you're not expecting your guy to be there. And I think that's where Marcus Washington lost the handle on it. But able to get back on it. Cardinals back under center.
5-minute mark here, third quarter. It's Connie Figueroa. He'll stumble forward to the 44-yard line.
Well, Randy, that was a hustle play by Leslie Deemer, and he is down on the sideline. He is on the Nicholls State sideline as he is running and doing his very best to get to Tuscany Figueroa. He takes one of those long swipes with the right paw, lands awkwardly. He does bring Figueroa down short of the first down, but man, that's just, you're talking about your star defensive lineman selling out. Coming up, making a great play. And
got Leslie Deemer right there on the Nicholls sideline.
Yeah, got a little dinged up doing it. He's fine, but you take another look at the replay on that, you'll see where he lands awkwardly after making that big swipe trying to trip Figueroa up, and he was able to do that. But it's really good to see him walking off under his own power. You see him moving that right shoulder around. That's where he landed. maybe we won't get a replay on it, but.
Colonels will huddle up here. Coach Stubbs, 4:42 to go, 27-7 lead. Last series, they marched down and fell short on that missed field goal. There's Coach Thomas knows his football team has some work to do here.
Big third down here, Andy. Figueroa under center.
Third to go here for the Colonels. Figueroa.
That's the
he
dimension.
Might have enough there. He just might have enough.
He does. That's the dimension Coach Stubbs was talking to Aaron about as he was going in before half, is that the feet, his ability, his athleticism, his speed. It's third and four. Not a lot going. Looked like he might have had a chance to throw the ball to Marcus Washington, but he knew he could pick up a third down, and he got it just by a whisker, but it was enough. And he knew he could get there, and he could beat the defense, outflank them, and just ran a sprint to the line and was able to come up with the first down.
Well, it's hobbling a little bit as well. I think he had some cramp issues a couple of plays ago. Figueroa came up hobbling a little bit after that sprint.
Defense there. Tyler Smith coming in, meeting. It's Keelan Johnson also, but meeting Marcus Washington at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play.
Checking back in, Brad Nelson, also number 80, Xavier Marcus, and Dalton Hilliard Jr. in the backfield, number 22 for Nicholls. Second down and 10 now. They need to get to the 30. Approaching the 3-minute mark, third quarter. Pass is caught.
Nifty
DeMond
move.
Bolt.
Nifty move by Bolt.
They're just kind of picking it apart, aren't they? Using great clock time, great clock management. Just little short dump offs like that to Bolt. Bolt's had himself a pretty good day so far.
And it's recognizing where the defense is coming from and where the coverage is going to. And Figueroa, again, not a lot of starts under his belt, Randy. But, man, he really is executing this offensive game plan to perfection today. Looking at another third down, third and about three.
Timeout. Looks like Charlie Stubbs called a timeout. The Colonels of Nicholls will talk it over with 2:27 to go, third quarter. Nicholls trying to answer back. They're leading 27-7 here in Thibodeau. We're coming right back.
Are you sure we should take this billboard down?
People find out State Farm does car loans as well as they do insurance. Our bank is through.
Good point. Grab an edge.
Look, there's two guys on the State Farm Borrow Better Banking sign.
No, for real, there's two dudes on the State Farm
Borrow Better Banking sign.
Gentlemen, please get down from the State Farm Borrow Better Banking sign. Bill, get the hose.
Okay, he's getting the hose.
All right, let's go.
Want to borrow better? Contact your local State Farm agent about a car loan that could save you hundreds.
Back here at Guidry Stadium here in Thibodeau. Colonels have talked it over, and with 2:27 to go, they've got a yard to go here on a second down or third down play coming up now for Nicholls. Go, Figueroa hands it off to Washington. He's got enough for the first down and then a few extra inside the 30-yard line, and the chains will move for the Cardinals.
I tell you what, third down efficiency for this Cardinals offense has just been spectacular all game long. Marcus Washington did a good job of knowing what he needs. And that's what I like about this, Randy. Look, when you know that you need to get a yard to 2 yards, you don't see as much flash and dash. You see a lot more grounded out and just pounding it up the middle, making sure that you're going to get the yards. Washington did a great job on that run to pick up the first down.
Figueroa over the middle. He's got an open receiver. Pass is caught inside the 5-yard line. That is, I believe, Josh Dudley. Backup tight end filled in for Nick Scalfo, his first catch of the afternoon.
Well, Dudley is wide open, and Toscani figured a good job on a little play action pass, but you see Dudley running free in the secondary, and he's a big target. Comes up with an easy pitch and catch. Got the ball down first and goal down on the 4-yard line. Hayden Cardiff had a great catch earlier in the first half. Randy out of that tight end spot. And now Josh Dudley coming up big.
Washington up the middle. He's in the end zone. 6 more for the Colonels. The fans are on their feet here on the Nicholls side. Exciting brand of football here on the home field today. Well, Nicholls is stuck with their game plan, Shea, from the get-go. And even with the big lead, you know, a team that's not used and accustomed to winning a lot of football games, you can't let panic set in, but they've stuck to their guns here. And mission accomplished so far. They now lead it 33-7.
Well, they have looked impressive on offense, Randy, as you said, in really just executing to perfection. And the things that they've done and dominated just this game with that front five has just been fantastic. And, you know, putting the points on the board, representing that also.
All right, one of the great awards across the country is the Jerry Rice Award. It's for the top FCS freshman in the nation. And the watch lists include Adebo from Sam Houston State. You see the numbers right there, 15 total tackles, 3 sacks already. Trent Britton, the quarterback from the University of Incarnate Word, over 1,100 yards passing, 7 touchdowns. The presentation is going to be in the middle of December on the 16th in Philadelphia. The Jerry Rice Award for the top FCS freshman in the country. Good luck to those guys.
Yeah, you talk about it. You just said in the country, in the Southland Conference, with 2 players on that list. Jerry Rice Award would be pretty cool.
Not a bad name to have on a piece of hardware, is it?
FCS freshman. That's fantastic. It's great to have a couple players representing the Southland Conference on that list. Hopefully they can hang on.
Ed Egan, again, will take a knee like he's done most of the day. He's brought one out.
I'm thinking this looks like Groundhog Day when Ed Egan is catching that ball at the same spot on the field, about the same depth in the end zone, and going to a knee each time, other than that one that he did return.
All right, so if you're on that Demon sideline right now and you're Jay Thomas and the staff, what are you telling your guys? I mean, you've got a minute 22 to go third quarter. You're starting to look at the clock. It's going to be a concern here pretty quick.
Yeah, you know, I don't think they're really talking to him about doing anything other than getting out there and just executing. Make a sound play. Make a sound play. Know your assignment and execute. And then just let the chips fall where they may. Right now, it's just been a kind of a helter-skelter. They got that one long run by Daniel Taylor. But other than that, Randy, it's been a fairly anemic effort by the Demons offense.
That is
a good play call right there.
Pass is caught around the 38-yard line. That's Tough McLean with the catch. McLean, wide receiver. He's a freshman from Spring, Texas. Played his ball at Klein Oak High School.
Very good combination route. McLean does a nice job of getting open and coming up with the grab.
Ramil Morris, his turn there, the senior. On that carry, let's update the scoreboard now. fourth quarter in Huntsville delayed. I assume that's weather delay.
Yep, lightning delayed. I've already got that message.
Yeah, that a few weeks ago against Eastern Washington. Bearcats, I'll tell you what. How about Lamar hanging tough against the number two team in the nation? Sam Houston State up 14-3 in that delay. You see the update as well from Conway in that Central Arkansas ball game. Second down and seven. Atkins chased out of bounds. Throws it away just in time. Pursuit on the play by Ryan Bruno and company for Nicholls.
Well, Corey Simmons, Randy, was wide open running all alone for the Demons offense. And as Zach Atkins was rolling out, you can see the coaches getting excited because they thought that he was going to come into his field of vision. He was just below the numbers on the right side. That's where Atkins rolled out too, but the pressure from the Colonels defense ended up forcing him to pitch it out of bounds. Big third down right here.
They need a conversion right now. See the cheerleaders on the sidelines wearing pink, supporting breast cancer awareness today. Seen a lot of that across the country.
Well, the blitz came in. Davin Bovey does a good job of leveling Zach Atkins before he can get rid of the ball, and just took a little bit too long. He's going to force a punt.
Well, this is not what Northwestern State wanted. They needed a productive drive, and third quarter's not even up yet. They're having to give the football back.
No, it puts a lot of pressure on your defense when the offense goes without much success in sustaining a drive. DeMond Bolt standing at his own 25-yard line. See where he actually ends up fielding this one. If he does, looks like he'll get a chance to.
Looking for help. He's going to be met and tripped up there around the 18-yard line.
Good special teams coverage there by the Demons punt coverage team. Pushed him about another six or seven yards. 12 ticks left, Randy, in the third quarter, and so far so good for the Colonels.
Now you take a one quarter at a time, don't you, when you're going to rebuild your program. You try to win quarters and get those W's when it's all said and done, and they're on their way. They're trying to snap that drought, end the drought in the Southland Conference, where they have gone winless and try to make a giant step. Because there's a lot of football left this season. This will potentially go a long way for their confidence for the rest of the year. Marcus Washington crosses the 20, pickup of 2, maybe 3 yards, and on that play, the clock goes to zeros here. End of three quarters at Thibodeau. Going to the fourth, Nicholls trying to hang on. They lead 33-7 over Northwestern State.
Kids witness bullying. They want to help, but don't know how. Teach your kids how to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
Thanks for calling the GED Pep Talk Center. Jerry Siller speaking. Your level 7 in your face pep talk.
I can keep pushing. Believe me, I'm good at it. But at some point, you're going to need to start pushing yourself.
See, once you've got your GED diploma, you'll feel so good about yourself.
You tough.
You can't change your past, but you can definitely change your future.
That makes me so happy, I'm ready to bust out a dance.
Mr. Trejo, can I transfer this guy to you? My gentle technique isn't really working. You need something a little more
persuasive.
Yes.
You listen, and you listen good.
Hey, where's my sandwich? Jerry? Jerry?
Take it from me to King DMC. It's a real cool thing to get your GED.
Get that diploma!
Now hold on and we'll find you free GED classes. Capiche?
Whatever motivation you need, we've got a pep talk for you. Get your GED pep talk and find free classes at yourged.org.
People think I'm trash, but they're wrong. Today I'm just an aluminum can, but one day I could be a stadium.
live in Thibodaux, Louisiana. All quiet on the Northwestern State side, and things look pretty relaxed on the Nicholls side as well. I guess they're comfortable with this 33-7 lead for Coach Stubbs and the Colonels.
Well, they got their offense on the field too, so a little bit comforting there. And you see Bo Hebert checking in for the first time today, Randy.
Hebert making his first appearance, second down and 10. He takes a hit, fumbles the football, and Northwestern State is going to recover at the 15-yard line.
We'll take another look at who forced the fumble. It was a tomahawk, and you'll see as Bo Hebert starts to go forward, he doesn't see what he wants. It's number 92.
Check, Leroy Armstrong.
Got to check the board there for Leroy Armstrong. Tyler Roussel had a chance to cover that ball. Did not, but Evans comes up with it.
Armstrong back after a concussion that kept him out of last week's game. So it was a week, what week the situation before. Would be. Week before, actually missed the game last week. And he's back out there and made a big play there. So turnover. Let's see if Northwestern State can take advantage early in the fourth quarter here.
Well, they started off the third quarter with a bang and a score. Let's see what they can do here.
Atkins caught. Pass is caught by Brian Mitchell. So Bo Hebert coming in there on that situation there in offense for Nicholls State. You saw Toscani Figure on the sidelines. You think perhaps the cramp issues came into play?
No. I just think that Coach Stubbs was rotating Hebert in, and you really hate to see a negative play like that happen for him. But, hey, it did, and now Northwestern State is back on the board. Another, even albeit a short one, a two-play drive for a touchdown.
Daniel Taylor in for the touchdown for the Demons, and they strike quickly here in the fourth quarter. Quick turnover by Nicholls, and it didn't take long at all for Northwestern State to punch it in. One after attempt coming up now for Northwestern State. Chris Moore with the honors. He is 16 of 17 on point afters this year. Knocks that one right down the middle. Moore's a transfer from Iowa State, handling the kicking job now, because we all know John Shaughnessy, the
all-everything
kicker.
Highly decorated.
Absolutely, and Chris Moore with some big shoes to fill, but stepping in this season. So there's Daniel Taylor with the touchdown for Northwestern State. So now we're looking at a 33-14 lead. Still a nice cushion for the Colonels, but when you give it up and you score two plays later, this lead can evaporate rather quickly here.
Well, and again, I talk about this for Bo Hebert, and it really is too bad because he gets his first opportunity to come into the game. Figueroa has just played lights out, and these guys have been rotating, Randy, through the first five games of the year. And to come in and get on your first play, get stripped of the ball, you have to protect the ball. You have to be mindful of that. But he wasn't, and again, great play by the Northwestern State defense. And give the offense a lot of credit for punching it in two plays and scoring a touchdown, taking advantage of that field position. But it'll be interesting to see, and I'm hoping Coach Stubbs will send Hebert back out, because that's from a confidence standpoint, you want to make sure that he gets out there and gets some more plays under his belt.
Kickoff right through the end zone. Nicholls will get the football here, up 33-14. Let's toss it down to Aaron Cofield. Now you got an update on the NSU Challenge. How about that piece of hardware?
I do. I found myself some hardware. There is more than just pride on the line here. There is this wooden trophy. This is actually the 20th year of this challenge. In 1993, the student government of both schools said, you know what? We want it to be about more than just a football game. It's that name, NSU. This trophy went missing during Jay Thomas's tenure here at Nicholls. They found it in a closet. They fixed it up, and they said, you know what? We're using this as motivation for our team to really bring some excitement back to this game against Northwestern at the time from Coach Thomas.
All right, very good. Nice looking piece of hardware there. Not bad. Yeah, you put that on display and something to brag about.
Yes, you bet. But hey, So Bo Hebert back in the game, Randy. Good to see him back in there making plays. And
well,
defensively,
you
Justin Evans. That's what I'm saying, yeah. His head would be not in the right place, but Justin Evans making a big play for the Demons defense.
Evans having a good year. He's a junior. 3.5 sacks already on the season for him coming in.
Well, coming up with a negative play on first down, that's the way you want to start on defense.
Loss of 3, so second down and 13 now for the Colonels. Pass is caught by Washington.
Washington just got leveled by Roussel.
Roussel was right there
to meet
him at the 20-yard line. And there's Washington right there. He's feeling that.
Yeah, check a filling or two. He's coming off the field, a little bit of a limp. But take a look at the hit that Tyler Roussel timed it perfectly. Yep, clean hit. Like the way he led with his shoulder. And you know, there's so much emphasis now on how to hit. When you see a defenseless player, you see a guy that's just now catching the ball and making sure that you're not using the crown of your head and or going above the shoulders of that player.
Hey, Bear being chased out. He's going to be brought down at the 13-yard line. Down he goes. Nice defensive series by Northwestern State. Tackle made on the play by Northwestern State's Sylvester Grimble, the freshman from Gretna, Louisiana. And another loss. Fourth down coming up now for Nicholls. And Northwestern's going to have good field position coming up. These guys are around midfield.
Well, how about the closing speed by Grimble? He had Hebert in his sights as Bo Hebert was rolling out to his right. He kept thinking that he was going to have somebody flash open downfield, but it never materialized. And Grimble just was on his horse and stayed right and had a good line on him, stayed targeted right on him and was able to bring him down for the big sack. Wow, what a great Colonel bounce on that punt.
Inside the 40. Nice punt there by number 93, Connor Freeu. Northwestern State gets it back. Plenty of time left here in the fourth.
The State Farm Southland Conference Mascot Challenge is back. This year's field is bigger and stronger. Willie the Wildcat. Bruce D-Bear. Mingo the Husky. Red the Cardinal. Big Red the Cardinal. Rowdy the Cowboy. Lafitte the Instigator. Colonel Talu. Vic the Demon. Eli the Eagle. Rumi the Lion. The Lumberjack. Izzy the Islander. And defending champion, Sammy the Bearcat. $5,000 is on the line. Vote for your favorite on the Southland Conference Facebook page.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'm on it. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
You're covered, Kevin.
Thanks, Melinda.
Wait, I have blah blah insurance, so person, come help.
Hey, Grandma.
Six callers ahead of us, Jimmy.
You're not helping.
Having insurance isn't the same as having State Farm. There to help you anytime, anywhere, anyway. That's getting to a better state.
Contact your local State Farm agent.
I'm Leslie Dean, senior defensive tackle from Northwestern State, and I am Southland Strong.
All right, welcome back to Thibodeau. Northwestern State gets it back on the move again. Daniel Taylor with the carry. He's had himself a nice second half so far. They're feeding him the football a little more often.
Hey, on first down, that was a great run. Picks up another first down, moves the chains. Davin Bovee on the tackle there on the nickel sideline, but not after a good run by Taylor. He's got some speed now.
And off Taylor again up the middle. He's going to be brought down around the 39-yard line. And the tackle made on that play by number 52 for Nicholls. That's Cameron Brown. So they're not wasting any time here. They're trying to keep this offense, keep the rhythm going here. Hurry up.
And seemingly having some success. Ooh, what a great stiff arm right there. DeMar Lorenz does a good job of stiff arming. Keep the defender off of him. Still didn't pick up a whole lot of yards, but it's a positive gain. And you know, you'd much rather third and one or third and a half than third and three or four. You just wonder how much, Randy, does the presence of Robbie Brown, the offensive coordinator, coming out of the booth, going down on the field for this Demons offense.
Atkins on the keeper.
Kind of hard to argue the results so far. Good job by that front. Well, pushing forward, Tisha Kidd player, number 79, 6'6", 298 pounds senior, kind of leader on that offensive front.
Time for an injury update. Let's check in once again with Aaron Cofield. Aaron?
Well, two for you. Nick Scalfo now has his cleat off. That right ankle is taped and covered with ice. Also, Marcus Washington, I'm told he got hit in the front of the knee, so they're checking it out to see. I'm told that he will, quote, be out for a nap. So we'll have to keep an eye on that.
All right, thank you, Aaron. Yeah, we get a good look from up here, the busy area down there by the trainer's table. Scalfo and Washington getting worked on.
Two really important players. Washington, obviously, kind of got that little wicked shot and kind of a combination of things.
Ooh. Pass intended for Taylor right off his fingertips.
Yeah, Randy, those are the kinds of plays that you have to make. And Daniel Taylor, that ball was a very catchable ball. Zach Atkins threw it out there, and with Taylor's speed, if he catches that ball in stride, yeah, that could have been a really big play for the Demons offense, but he wasn't able to hang on to it, and he goes out, and Etzenweiler comes back in.
Third down and six. Ball's loose low. Ball.
Covered by the Colonel defense.
They feel like they've got it, and they have it right there. Big turnover by Northwestern State here. Recovery, that's Chris Lorden, the linebacker, the redshirt freshman out of John Curtis High School in New Orleans.
He was at the right place at the right time, was Chris Lorden, because that ball was not handled cleanly by Atkins. You see, it's low into his right, and as he tries to field it, he just pushes it underneath the legs of Tisha Kidd player, and it rolls right into Lorden's hands. Does a great job of covering it, making sure that he secures it. Well, just when things seem like Northwestern State has something a little bit going, the errant snap, fumble recovery, and the Colonels back on the field on offense.
Bo Hebert back out again for a third series now for Nicholls. Those big guys up front, they just keep moving that pile. Well, right now, I'm looking down on the sidelines right now here, Shea, on Nicholls' side. You got a trainer working on Toscani Figueroa, that right shoulder area. Looks like they're trying to figure something out. So I don't know if there's kind of discomfort why he's not back out there, but he's getting worked on a little bit.
Yeah, hard to say for sure. Don't recall him really getting nicked or dinged anywhere, but you know, Bo Hebert has been a guy who has started for this Colonel's offense this season, and kind of a nice luxury for Coach Stubbs to have.
There's Hebert looking for Buchanan. Too much on that one. Well overthrown.
Damone Claiborne had great coverage there on the sideline. He and Buchanan got locked up, but there was no way that Buchanan was going to be able to get down to that ball. Third down, where the Colonels, Randy, have been outstanding all game. A big one here with 9 minutes and 14 seconds left. 33-14 lead for the Colonels. They pick this up and to make things very difficult for the Demons.
Third down and five from the 42. Hebert. Pass is caught. Bolt at the 48. Lunges forward to the 49. That'll be enough for a first down. So a big conversion there by the Colonels and Bo Hebert.
You just can't say enough about the offensive front. Kabasi Salimu, Rafe Plaisance, Brandon Holmes, Caleb Klein, Eric Alt, those guys doing a great job of giving the quarterbacks, both quarterbacks, time. Wide receivers can feel and know where to sit down inside where those zone openings are. Quarterback has that much time. That's easy pitch and catch. Rafe Plaisance, so you remember that name from the Bayou Bowl?
That's right.
He played in the Bayou Bowl, representing the state of Louisiana against the greater Houston area. High school All-Stars.
Game that still continues on. Hopefully it's got some more life in it. I know there's some logistical things they're trying to work out with that game, but it's good.
Yeah, that was
good,
a great
competition.
Game.
Good competition.
Yep. So when you start talking about the state of Louisiana and the Houston area, I mean, it's there's certainly enough athletes to play in that game. And it was fun to be a part of that for 6 or 7 years.
Second down and 8 now. They'll mark it at the 49-yard line. Clock continues to roll inside 8 minutes to play. Dalton Hilliard Jr. had a little space, but at the 45, he runs into about 3 or 4 Northwestern State Demon players to knock him back. Right now, let's get another injury update. Let's check in with Aaron Cofield. Aaron?
Well, guys, I found out about Toscani Figueroa. What I'm told is that a few series ago, he got hit pretty hard, and he is tight from that. If it was a bit closer of a ball game, he would likely be in the game. But since they have the lead and they have Bo Hebert, they're going to hold him out for now.
All right. Thanks for the update, Aaron. Appreciate that. Well, Figueroa certainly left his mark on this football game. If he doesn't return, he's shown he's got some talent. Led the Colonels today here. Third down and 4. Hebert looking for Hilliard.
Well, Hebert is under duress. Ryan Sorrell in his face the whole time, as was Adam Jones. There's Skelfo, you see there, number 85, and Marcus Washington. It's good to see him having a couple laughs and some positive things going on in Thibodeau and talking about this team and kind of some of the adversity, Randy, that they faced. This is the last time the Colonels won 3 games in a row. It was way back in 2007, defeating Azusa Pacific, Northwestern State, and Stephen F. Austin. But this is a big deal.
A little quick kick here by Bo Hebert.
Oh, Buchanan. That was almost a limbo move, trying to avoid the ball and making sure he didn't touch it, and he's able to go down and touch it down at the 1-yard line.
All right, break it away. 33-14 lead for the Colonels.
The State Farm Southland Conference Mascot Challenge is back. This year's field is bigger and stronger. Willie the Wildcat. Bruce D-Bear. Mingo the Husky. Red the Cardinal. Big Red the Cardinal. Rowdy the Cowboy. Lafitte the Instigator. Colonel Tolu. Vic the Demon. Eli the Eagle. Rumi the Lion. The Lumberjack. Izzy the Islander. And defending champion, Sammy the Bearcat. $5,000 is on the line. Vote for your favorite on the Southland Conference Facebook page.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'm on it. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
You're covered, Kevin.
Thanks, Melinda.
Wait, I have blah blah insurance, so person, come help.
Hey, Grandma.
6 callers ahead of us, Jimmy.
You're not helping.
Having insurance isn't the same as having State Farm. There to help you anytime, anywhere, anyway. That's getting to a better state.
Contact your local State Farm agent.
Back live in Thibodeau, 6:50 to go here, 4th and final quarter, 33-14. Mascot's kind of battling.
Yeah, look at Tolu, he's drawing the sword on Vic the Demon. Thought this was a friendly.
Contact, ball is loose. Looks like Northwestern State may have jumped on it there at about the 11-yard line.
Well, Zach Atkins, Randy, was stepping up in the pocket, trying to make a throw, get it down the field. But this Colonels defense closing in on him and nothing doing there. Chris Berman, he has had a really big game. Again, you just talk about an incredibly athletic linebacker. 6'1", 245 pounds. He gets after it.
Pass is caught there around the 28-yard line. Flag.
That's tough. Flag McLean slide on that grab.
Yeah, tough McLean. A little extra contact out of bounds. So we'll see if that's against Nicholls. I have a feeling it's going to be.
That's a nice play.
After the play was over, personal foul. Late hit out of bounds. Defense, number 16. 15-yard penalty. First down.
First down and 19 yards. You come up with a big play to Tough McLean. And then you get the additional 15 yards. So all of a sudden you're out there at your 46-yard line.
So that may have been on Jordan Hanbury or Nicholls. Like the Southland on Facebook, facebook.com/Southland Conference. Follow and keep up with everything Southland Conference. Digital network as well, all kinds of good stuff going on.
Yeah, Tough McLean had a chance to bring that ball in, Randy. It would have been another first down, but as the ball got to him, he was hit by the defender, not able to hang on to that. Here's a big offensive front for the Colonels. They have done a heck of a job today.
I'm gonna lie, never get enough respect, do they? Open space there. That's Robert Walker with the carry. Walker, the senior. Transferred into this program a couple years ago from Louisiana Lafayette.
Demons offense going very fast. Third and about a yard, and he is going to get the first down. That's Walker again on the carry.
Jay Thomas, first year head coach here at Northwestern State. Former assistant in the program and former head coach right here at Nicholls, where he won a Southland Conference championship. He was here from 04 to 09. Back as a head coach. Atkins over the middle. Big contact at the 22 to Tucker Nims. Tucker Nims, 262-pounder, and he just knocked a couple people to the ground.
He does a great job of catching the ball. Good throw here by Atkins. Gets it right over the top of the linebacker, down in front of the safety, and man, you see Nims lowering the shoulder, running right over the top of Segan Vigerl. Colonel helmet. That's Chris Ramon's helmet. He'll have to come off for a play. Dwayne Mitchell going in his place.
Second down now for Northwestern State. Under five to play here in Thibodeau. There's Walker inside the five, down to the three, maybe the 2 yard line.
When he can, the Demons can get a first down. This is going to be third and about one and a half yards. Get a first down without scoring.
Flags down.
You
had guys hustling off the field there for Nicholls.
It's going to be enough yardage for the first down. But let's see with the flag.
It's illegal substitution. Defense. Penalty is declined. The result of the play is first and goal.
Nicholls trying to hustle guys on and off the field. Get flagged for that. But first and goal to go down from the one. Atkins.
He's in.
Signal touchdown for Northwestern State. There he is. And with 4:18 to go, it's now a 13-point game between Nicholls and Northwestern State. Still a lot can happen in these next 4 minutes.
You bet. You bet. Jay Thomas is thinking exactly that.
after attempt coming up now for the Demons. Chris Moore again with the honors. Snap is good and the kick is up and good as well. So just like that, it's now 33-21. Northwestern State was buried and now they're starting to do a little rally here in Thibodaux. Hey, next Saturday's broadcast schedule, check it out. These same Colonels from Nicholls will hit the road, headed for Nacogdoches, taking on Stephen F. Austin, 3 o'clock kickoff on the network. Also at 6 p.m. Central, Central Arkansas visits Lamar in Beaumont. You can catch that on Comcast Sportsnet Houston. And on ESPN3, Sam Houston State, currently number 2 in the nation, heading to Lake Charles to take on McNeese.
Who's ranked number 9?
That'll be a top 10s going head to head.
There are 3 teams in the Southland Conference in the top 20. Central Arkansas hanging in there at number 20. But how about the McNeese State Cowboys? Number 9 after that big win up in Conway. Moved up a couple of notches in Sam Houston State.
Matt Viator's
just doing what they're doing.
Really do. Matt Viator's got really good talent on both sides of the ball.
Yeah, they do. They look really good.
He feels like this could be a special season. We'll find out. Veteran players on the McNeese team.
Well, and McNeese has a history of putting up powerhouse teams, and they have more Southland Conference championships than any other team. You see the Colonels right now, Randy, preparing for the onside kick. Yeah, I think with 4 minutes and 18 seconds left, you know, if you kick the ball to the 30-yard line right now, that's actually a good play because the deep back is standing on his 12-yard line. Well, that's not the 30. That's the end zone.
That'll go through, and Nicholls will take over now with 4:18 to go in this football game, up 33-21. Tell you about the 2014 NCAA Division I Football Championship. You ready for it? Saturday, January 4th at Toyota Stadium. It's a 1 o'clock kickoff in Frisco, Texas. For more information, log on to the website, ncaa.com/FCS. And we all know who's been in that game the past 2 years. It'll be Sam Houston State. North Dakota State.
The Bison have been tough on the Bearcats, but I tell you what, it's been 2 magical runs, Randy, for the Bearcats. Willie Fritz doing a great job down there in Huntsville.
First and 10 Colonels now from the 25-yard line where the series begins. Bo Hebert remains in quarterback. Hands off. That's Dalton Hilliard. Good yardage all the way out to the 33, perhaps 34-yard line. Second down and short now coming up for Nicholls.
We got an injured player down on the field for Northwestern State, maybe Pat Black.
Yeah, that is Pat Black down. Black, a senior from Jackson, Mississippi, Forest Hill High School. Jay Thomas does not want to lose his big-time playmaker on defense. Black came in, the leading tackler on this Demon football team, number 1 with 44 coming in, had a sack as well. One of the leaders out there. We'll get an update for you momentarily. All right, checking in, Xavier Marcus for Nicholls. Also, number 14, Josh Hanberry. 3:45 and counting now, fourth quarter.
It's a must stop for the Demons. They want to crawl back in this game. Oh, they're going to get a false start, Andy. Xavier Marcus out there on the top end of the screen.
Second down.
Move just a little bit right before the snap. But that takes you from second and 2 to second and 7. Ah. You know what Coach Stubbs is thinking? Nothing's ever easy. Nothing's ever easy. Here we are cruising right along, and that's a 2-score game.
Could this be a simple win? Yeah. Is that asking too much?
Could the first one be simple? Yeah. First conference win in 2 years. Still looking to secure it. Away there on the design run, Randy. You like to pay the quarterback manage that, right?
Good
he makes
there.
The play fake, and then he tucks the ball under his shoulder. He is not even looking downfield.
Timeout, Northwestern State. 33-21, 3:03 left. All right, let's take a look now. Yeah, I made my pick earlier. This is the Southland Conference 50th anniversary all-time football team presented by Mid-South Bank. Shea, your top running back.
I'll tell you what, this was a tough decision for me. Timothy Flanders has done anything and everything that you could imagine as a running back. But as you go back, and that was hard. I went back and forth on this one. I think of Claude Mathis.
Yep.
Yeah, Texas State, 1994, 5, 6, and 7. He was the leading rusher that Timothy Flanders surpassed. But also Scotty Caldwell out of Texas Arlington, 1982, 83, 84. He's all Southland Conference. You got Buford Jordan from McNeese. Roosevelt Potts from Louisiana. Yep. Monroe. I mean, there were a lot of guys to consider. But you just look at the body of work that Tim Flanders has in putting up massive numbers at that running back spot is just nothing short of heroic, and he's my pick.
And you know, he's not done yet. He's gonna keep shattering records.
Still early in the season. But I go back to that. You go back to Claude Mathis, and again, that his
one
rushing
of the big names,
his rushing record stood for many years. But not only did Claude Mathis have 4,600 and change yards running the ball, he had over 7,000 yards of total offense. Receiving, kick returns, punt returns. I mean, just doing it all. I mean, that's impressive.
Well, one thing I enjoyed looking at all the positions, and you know, the information given to us, we were able to read up on all these players. And you know, back in the 70s, I mean, you read about so many great players that made an impact in this conference. The style, the era of football obviously is different, but they all put up their own unique stats and made a difference for their programs out there. It's fun to learn about the history of this conference.
Yeah, certainly is. And you think about what, you know, there's been guys that have played in the Southland Conference who have put up monster numbers within a year or 2 years. But when you think about all-time guys, for me, I have a tendency to want to say, okay, were they able to do it for their career?
Mm-hmm.
And that's currently what kind of probably tipped the center for me, if you will, over to Tim Flanders. But, you know, again, you've got some outstanding running backs. John Stevens, of course, going on to play for the New England Patriots. And there's just so many good guys that are littered through there. He played for Northwestern State. Anyway, it's been a lot of fun. It was fun to kind of go through the list of guys and try to figure it. I'm an old school guy. You know that. So it was hard.
I do know that.
Flanders was a tough pick for me. But just, again, you look at that body of work and you say, man, the guy's just been so dominant.
Well, I saw him a couple of weeks ago when I had a chance to call the Sam Houston game with Eastern Washington, and he finished with what is the day he went over 5,000 yards. And there's Bo Hebert on the keeper there and got pressure there in the backfield. And another timeout coming up by Northwestern State. Stopped the clock at 2:19. Finished with, 260 yards against a really, really good defense at Eastern Washington. Just tore them up. And all kinds of respect there on that day. All right, timeout on the field. We'll talk it over at Nicholls sideline, as will the Demons for Northwestern State. Right now, let's toss it down to the sidelines. And once again, Aaron, what do you have for us now, Aaron?
Well, guys, I'm not sure if you've seen the picks for the quarterback yet, but someone that will likely be on that list would probably be Bobby Hebert from when he played at Northwestern State University, the Cajun Cannon.
Right.
This game, a little bit of a house divided, as that's his son, Bo, out there playing quarterback. So it runs in the family. Bo, though, wears 11. His dad wore number 12. That jersey's retired. One of just five retired at Northwestern State.
Big football family.
Yeah, we were giving Bobby Hebert some love earlier in the broadcast. Much deserved.
He's doing a lot of radio work now, and for the, I believe about the Saints, covering the Saints.
He's also
New Orleans area.
Yep.
Oh, pass is caught by Hilliard. Yeah, Hebert lofted it up there, and Hilliard went there and got it, and crosses midfield. down close to that 49-yard line.
The interesting thing about that, Dalton Hilliard catches that ball, and he is right beside Leslie Deamer, who is trying to jump and get his paw and his mitt to flick that away, but he's not able to do so. Hilliard makes a good catch and kind of finishes off a good run, and they're eating up a lot of clock now, Randy, and that's exactly what Coach Stubbs wants to see happen.
Yeah, they're no rush. Fourth down play. They're going to let this play clock go down 10 seconds now, 1:39 overall on the clock. And they'll take a delay of game, I have a feeling. Or a timeout. Yeah, they'll call a timeout. Yeah. Timeout with 1:31 to play. And Nicholls will kick it away, leading by 12 over Northwestern State. All right, let's take a look now if we can. Players of the week now in the Southland Conference. Let's begin with Marcus Wiltz. Senior running back, we were there at Conway, Shea. Look at those numbers he put
up. He was dominating in that game. And what you're going to notice, there'll be a familiar theme to the player of the week here for the Southland Conference. Checking out. Oh,
free safety from McNeese. Brian Bronson, he had that big interception return a week ago.
Yeah, he picked off Winrick Smothers and lugged it back in for 98 yards. That was outstanding. So, and we'll get the special teams player here in just a minute.
All right, punt is off. Ed Egan, fair catch around the 16-yard line. And one other player of the week from special teams now in the Southland Conference. It's a sweep by McNeese.
When we talk about Matt Theotar and the athletes that he's got down there and really coming up big and having a great game, all those three guys did against the Bears of Central Arkansas, and very much deserving of the awards this week.
And again, next week, Nicholls will travel to Nacogdoches to take on the SFA Lumberjacks on the Southland Conference TV Network. 3 o'clock kickoff again next Saturday, Homer Bryce Stadium in Nacogdoches. We look forward to having you with us on the broadcast. Atkins chased out of bounds. Clock will stop with 1:17 to go. So if they can hold on, a very monumental win here for Nicholls in this program, Shea.
Well, it's certainly a step in the right direction, and I'm sure that's what Coach Stubbs is thinking right now, is that are we making the right plays? Are we positioning ourselves to win games and putting ourselves to be in contention late in the game? And that's where you want to start. And it's obviously great to get your first conference win, the first in two seasons, and this is the first conference game of the year for the Colonels.
Atkins over the middle.
And it's nothing
incomplete.
Nothing more than a couple more plays here, and Coach Stubbs can take a deep breath. But what a great job for him, the staff, the players, the fans. I mean, it's been a long drought for the Colonels, and to see some positive signs of life and getting the fans, community, student body back engaged in the game, it's a great sight.
Third down play now, Atkins. Again, that falls incomplete as well. Pass intended for Daniel Taylor. Everybody's happy on that Nicholls sideline, and the fans on their feet as well. They appreciate the progress these guys have made and the work put in by Coach Stubbs and his staff.
Well, you got to learn how to win, Randy. These guys have to learn how to win. That's what they're doing. Yeah, I tell you, just again, a very dominating performance by the offensive line and really the skill position guys, and the best formation a coach could ever see.
Well, that opening loss at Oregon. And then since then, despite that setback to Lafayette, this will be 4 wins in 5 games for the Colonels.
Well, the players are just chomping at the bit, Randy, to race onto the field, and the coaches are trying their very level best to keep them back. Hey, listen, there's a lot of pent-up excitement, and there should be. the way Bears are going to let the clock go to zeros, and you'll see a much deserved and enjoyed celebration here. And they've got the trophy. First thing that they did, Randy, yeah, with the dead sprint, they've got the NSU trophy.
You got about a dozen players over there. They just kind of barely touched hands across the field. They wanted that hardware.
Good game. Off to the trophy.
Yeah, the band's excited. So are the fans here. It's a final 33-21. And I think Aaron Cofield's already routed up the head coach, Charlie Stubbs, and starts down the field right now. Aaron?
Coach, several streaks have been broken this season. Here's another one. First conference win in 14 tries. How proud are you of your team?
I'm very proud. I mean, we played some good football today. We've got to clean up a few things like every coach would say. But, again, I'm proud of them. It's three wins right in a row for Nicholls, 4 out of 5. And so we're building on it. And, again, I was glad all three phases contributed positively in this win.
When you look at this game, what do you think it was that really made the difference for your team?
I think we came out really solid on offense. And then on defense, we were solid, which we've been much maligned on defense. But I thought that they came in, played an excellent game. The times that they did score on us was pretty much penalties or gave them some momentum plays.
All right, thanks. Enjoy that trophy.
Thank you very much.
Guys.
All right, Aaron, thank you very much. And there is that hardware, the NSU Challenge. They've got the hardware to put on display somewhere in this athletic complex. They'll have fun with that. We'll wrap it up when we come back. 33-21 final today.
Think of the NCAA as a spirit squad, cheering for student athletes at every big event and every small one. We'd be there in the classroom, at graduation, at their first job interview. Okay, so don't think of us as a spirit squad. Think of us as a mascot. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes.
In the NCAA Division I Football Championship Subdivision, the game is played with perseverance, integrity, passion, character, and sportsmanship as he works to honor the game and respect his teammates, opponents, officials, and fans. Every FCS player grows in his responsibilities as a student athlete and as a member of his campus and community. The NCAA Division I Football Championship Subdivision. Every down, every day.
The Colonels will swing their swords and the Lumberjacks will chop some wood. 3 o'clock Saturday on the Southland Conference Television Network.
Back live at Thibodeau, wrapping up a 33-21 victory for Nicholls over Northwestern State. Let's take a look at the Southland Strong player of the game now from this afternoon. Lots to choose from, especially on the Nicholls side, Shea, but let's take a look at that and talk about the difference makers.
Marcus,
one of them right there,
Marcus Washington. Well-deserving, Randy, of the award and the recognition. He had a big game today. Had 4 touchdowns on the ground coming into today's game. He scored 3 today and really ran the ball well in between the tackles and kind of gave his team a boost, not just running the ball, but he also had some big catches and converted on third downs. And nice game there by Marcus Washington. And it's kind of a big deal for this Nicholls team. And you see Coach Stubbs down there explaining to him, this is what we've been doing. This is what we're going to continue to do. Stick with it. Congratulations on the win.
Yeah, they'll go celebrate this for, 24 hours and then get refocused. They've got a date in Nacogdoches next week against the Lumberjack from Stephen F. Austin. And there's the information on that. 3 o'clock kickoff right here on the Southland Conference Television Network. So the Colonels go home happy. The drought is over. They get a conference win and a 3-game winning streak. For the entire crew, I'm Randy McAvoy. For Shea Walker, Aaron Cofield, so long from Thibodeau, Louisiana.